Going on there, chat. Welcome to Big Rig Frosta Gaming. How the heck's everyone doing out there? Welcome to the Zilonka series. This is episode 3. And we're continuing our work. We're in the month of December, and we're just getting it done. I think the end of episode 2, we still had quite a bit of carrots and parsnips to harvest. Well, I found a modded pull-behind harvester that works excellent. I got that all finished. Everything was delivered to the soup factory, and I'm already in the process of flipping the fields. This one, we're putting soybean in. And then the one over there, I think we're putting parsnips in. So we rotated the carrots with parsnips. And then I got a big contract going on. If you saw the harvester going during the intro, that's a big contract that's going to give us, you know, a little chunk of extra money to pay off some leased equipment. And yeah, so it's going to be a lovely night. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Yeah, we got 28,000 liters of canola in the back of the truck here. And it looks like our harvester is on the final swipe of the contract, so we'll already have the contract knocked out. What's up, everybody? EY Blue Dragon, Mitch Blazinski, Chab Carlson, Philip Dean, Logan Goddard, Matt Bruxvirt, Sean Briley, UK London, Matt Matheson. Welcome, everybody. What's up, Bradley and Joshua Hoffman, Aaron Ashlock. We got Abraham Mendez. Mr. Vambooski was one of the first in the chat. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Do you like that? I posted a short today. I took my son and his friend. He's got the whole week off for Thanksgiving break. So we went fishing earlier today. And we were catching all kinds of catfish. We fished for like 2.5 hours, I'd say. About 2.5 hours. And I think my son caught 3 catfish. And it wasn't your normal catfish. It was like a blue. Anybody ever seen blue catfish? It's got like a blue tint to it. He caught 3 of them. I caught 1. And his friend he brought caught 2. So we caught a total of 6 catfish in about a 2-hour time span. But it was fun. It was a nice little area we went fishing at. So worked out pretty nice. What's up, Chris Smith? Chris Muncher, hello Thomas Hyman, hello there, sir. Alright, all done harvesting. Get this thing folded up. We'll bring it back to the house. What you doing for Thanksgiving, Frosty? We're having friends come over to have Thanksgiving with us. So it's gonna be just a small our family and friends. So 2 families having a Thanksgiving dinner at home. You got the whole week off, man? Yeah, my son still has basketball practice, which he should be getting home from any minute now. Miss Frosty had to go pick him up. But other than that, I think he doesn't have practice till Friday. So that's like the only other thing going on other than just chilling out for his vacation break. We got 1 stack Mac. My goodness. What are you doing, Lottie? Chase. 1 stack Mac dropping a massive $50 super chat right out of the gates. Says, hi, Daddy. Holy crap. Thank you very much, Mr. Morrison. Holy moly. Mac Morrison coming in with a massive super chat. Thank you very much, sir. You are very kind. I do appreciate it. And we've missed you. I know I've missed you. I always ask,
where's... Thank you.
Don't I, chat? Don't I always say, like, where's 1 stack at? Where's he at? But I know you've been farming. He's a real farmer, chat. He's been pretty busy getting the harvest in at the end of the season and all kinds of stuff going on. So it looks like you posted a little video, too. I think things are almost done for the season. Oh, things aren't as hectic, so we'll probably see 1 stack in the chat more often now. What's up, Donald Everett? Good evening. Jason Schisler. Joe No says, I can't get mine to work. Every time I hook up to the cedar, my tractor moves on its own and won't steer. I don't know. That's weird. Here's what's driving me nuts, chat. Look at this. This is what I don't understand. It's still doing this. And I don't know why. So I used the Ridge Maker. Anybody else having this issue? I used the Ridge Maker. And then I planted after making ridges. And it still leaves all this weird green texture. But then it doesn't do it on, like, a couple swipes. Like, what the heck's going on here? Why is it doing that? And is there a way to fix it? Or is it just... is that just, like, kind of broken with the new expansion? Anybody else having this issue? So this is all fresh planted parsnips. But I got this wacky texture going on, and I don't know why. And it doesn't seem to matter if I use the Ridge Maker or if I don't use it. Either way, that weird texture shows up. I don't know. Didn't know if anybody else was having that issue also. Are you going to play Survivor Series this week? I would like to. I think we will, yeah. I might even do that tomorrow. And then I have another... oh, crap. Dang it. And I have another new map that I want to show you guys that we're going to start a new series on this week. But that'll be a surprise. That'll be a surprise, okay? But yeah, we've gone a little too long without the Survival Series. So I'll probably do an episode of that this week. My guess is a game glitch. I even uninstalled the game and reinstalled it, and I'm still having the same trouble, says Joe. Yeah, I don't know about your problem. I don't know. We're done finally. Now it's on to cleaning everything. We even got a new 2022 combine in the middle of the season. I saw that. I was looking. I think you posted a photo of it. Yeah. So you've been a busy man. Thank you so much for the massive super chat, Mr. Morrison. Very kind of you, sir. All right, chat. Harvester, we're going to park it up. I just wanted to knock out a big contract. We do have to deliver the contract, the canola, so we can get paid. All right. So let's head back over there where the truck is. And I think we only got to deliver it right here at the grain mill. It's like right next to us, so pretty convenient contract. And this is one of the larger fields on this map. It's about a little over 9 acres, so not too bad. All right, I'm hearing all kinds of booming going on. I'll let all the booming stop. There's going to be like 10 booms in the chat. One stack is... one stack's on fire tonight with the support. Now, what's up, Glenn Maid? Loving the new maps with William Smith. I like it, too. I really do. And now that we have, like, a nice harvester, I like it even more. So, from this point forward, chat, doing the new root crops is not going to be painful. It's actually pretty easy. And I edited the mod that I downloaded to hold 50,000 liters. So it's not going to be all that back and forth constantly. Like, it's going to run for quite a while without needing emptied, which is going to save us a ton of time. Holy cow, that's a lot of booming going on. Jeez. We got one stack, Mac. Coming in with 10 Big Rig Frosty Gaming gifted memberships. Sorry about all the booms. Usually we don't get 10 in a row like that, so a lot of booming going on. Thank you so much again, One Stack Mac. Woo! All right, who all got a gifted sub? Chris Muncher, UK London, Metro Michael Gaming, Mitch Blazinski, EY Blue Dragon, that's the first five. Then we had David McCormick, Jordan Kenny, Dylan Johnson, Dublin Games, and Matt Bruxvort. All 10 of you getting gifted memberships, which is 30 days of membership for free on One Stack Mac, who was kind enough to send that on over to you. So thank you so much again, Mr. Morrison. My goodness, laddie. I'm doing all right, Mountain. I'm doing good. How you doing, buddy? All right, so here's our contract. We have 33,441 liters of canola in the trailer. We're going to get bonus money. Top right corner, we're down to $8,800. So we're kind of low on the dough. But don't you worry. When we skip to the next month, we are going to be filthy rich. Wait till you see how much our soup factory is going to make. It's going to be pretty crazy. All right, let's not collide with the wall here. All right, 63% has been transported. All right, we got a 5,900 bonus on extra canola. Very nice. So, wow, that is really good. So we got about $6,000 on bonus crops. That's without even turning in the contract. So now let's complete the contract and make an even nicer chunk of money. So there's our extra $6,500 for completing it. Bada bing, bada boom. That brings us up to just a little under $22,000, ladies and gentlemen. Not a bad way to start the night, doing a contract, helping out the other farmers in the neighborhood, you know? Gotta help. Oh, can't go this way. Gotta help out your neighbors. And we get a little discount if we ever want to buy that land. Thank you, buddy. Thank you, One Stack. What's up, Richard Singer? Happy Thanksgiving. Not quite Thanksgiving yet, but yeah. Happy Thanksgiving soon. When is Thanksgiving? Thursday or is it Wednesday? I think it's Thursday. 21, 22. Yeah, Thursday is Thanksgiving. So we got a little ways to go. It's only Monday. What's up, Waylon Timlick? We got Mr. Fireslaying also sending a gifted membership. This one's going to Alan Williams. Alan Williams, congratulations. You're on the receiving end of a big, big Frosty membership. That a nice. And thank you, Mr. Fireslaying. Thank you so much, guys. This upcoming Thursday. All right, truck's empty. Contracts are done. Well, that was the only contract I was doing. So we're going to go ahead and park this over at the store because they got a nice big parking lot to store my truck at. I'm just going to sand it on over here. Park it next to our nice auto trailer we purchased on the last episode, which we will be using tonight. Alright, we'll disconnect from that and shut her down. Put the lights off. There we go. Beautiful. Alright, we just got some equipment to put away. And I think we might have to do some lime. I don't know if I have to do anything. This field will need fertilizer. So I'm going to spray this field with liquid fertilizer. This is our fresh parsnips I just planted. And then this guy over here that did the soybean. We don't have to touch this field. It is in perfect condition. So we just got to get the equipment put away and we're good to go. That a nice. If anybody missed episode 2, we did purchase a new tractor. We traded in that ugly, slow one that was part of the premium expansion. We sold that and got this nice IMT, which has like 210 horsepower. So this one's got a little more muscle. It's good for pulling any of the tools we have. And it's good for running to the stores and delivery points if we have to use it. It does a good job. Alright, we'll have this guy follow us back. I also sold the little tiny premium expansion little planter we had. We had a little baby one. I traded it in for the bigger one. So now instead of whatever it was like 2 meter. This has like a 6 meter work width. So it gets the job done way faster. And it holds like 24 liters instead of 16. But yeah, it does good. It's a nice little machine. So we'll get these brought back to the yard, get them sprayed down and parked up. Go. Very nice. What's up, Adam Groves? Dustin Larson? I had a great weekend. I did have a nice weekend. Had a nice day today also. Got to take my son and his friend fishing. It's just a nice day together. He's got the whole week off, so get to spend time with the kids a little more than usual this week. What is tonight? Monday night. Oh, yeah, there's Monday night football. Who's playing? The Chiefs? The Chiefs and who else? Who else is playing? I had a slight itch to watch football this weekend, but ended up staying busy outside with the kids. So the itch went away pretty fast. What's up, Ian Oppenheim? Hello, hello. David Turville, good evening. Yeah, this little tractor you can get off the mod hub. I think it's actually a medium-sized tractor. And it's really good for a map like this. Starting out, if you have like smaller equipment, it's a nice workhorse tractor. What's up, Alan? Dennis Giersch, good evening. Are they playing the Eagles? The Chiefs and the Eagles, eh? Very nice. Alright, let's get this sprayed off. We'll also get these planter and cedars topped off with seed so they're ready to go for the next mission later on. Chiefs and Eagles from Kansas City. What's up, Kevin Wilson? Corey Eichmann. Hello. Hello, Mr. Eichmann. So yeah, I turned back in the leases. We had like two, I think on the end of episode two, we had two pull behind harvesters that we leased out. Well, I returned those, and now we have this awesome machine here. This thing is sweet. It's called the Rootster 604, and it's color changeable. And it's got a 4 meter work width, which is huge compared to the one we were using. But the best part of all, see this big basket? I edited it to hold 50,000 liters of root crop, and it can do all of them. It can do beets, potatoes, red beet, carrots, parsnips, you name it. This bad boy can haul it and hold it, and it gets the job done. I'd say probably 10 times faster than the other one. No more pain, chat. We can finally enjoy the premium expansion with a nice machine. All right, let's get this stuff topped off so it's full and ready for next season. We got a lot of harvesting coming up tonight. Once we fast forward to the next month, we should have quite a few fields ready to go. Alright, get this filled up. And I still have leftover seeds. Like, these implements just, like, sip on the seeds, which is awesome. Saves us a ton of money. Alright, so that's good to go. And we'll do the same for this, get it topped off. I wonder if I have to unfold. No, I shouldn't have to unfold this to fill it up. That's a funky implement. I dig it, says Ian. That's right. Well, that's actually, I think that's already in the game. But it's an edited version. So I think it's a normal potato technology. No, beet technology. So see this guy right here? the Rootster. It's already in Farm Sim. It's sitting right here. But this one has a 3-meter work width. This is the base game one. And then this is the mod that we have. And like I said, you can change the color. But it has a 4-meter work width. And I edited it to hold 50,000 liters. So it's a game changer in my opinion. Because that was just not fun. Going back and forth as much as we were, that was a little painful. So I am super happy to not have to do that anymore. All right, let's get the bag a little closer here. There we go. See the lids opened there. Very nice. Very nice. Fill it up. Okay, so this holds 32 liters. I was wrong. I said 24. It holds 32. But yeah, it gets the job done. It's nice. Nice little planta. All right, so next we have to spray the fresh parsnip field. So we'll hop into the Fiat and hook up to the Mammoth sprayer, which should already have plenty of liquid fertilizer in it. And we'll get a little spray down, and then that field will be ready to rock and roll. There we go. Is that the International Harvester 700 Turbits? I don't know. It's the one that just came out like 2 weeks ago, that little $1.49 DLC. Hydro 1066. Yeah, nice little tractor. You get that and then that little modern case tractor. It's like a 2-pack for like $1.49 or something. Yeah, so this field of sorghum will be ready when we skip time for the next month. That'll be ready, and I think we'll have an oat field that'll also be ready to knock out.
But first, we've got to drop some liquid down on my parsnips, okay?
I got I got my camera in the wrong spot. Gotta slide myself over a little bit.
I gotta slide myself over, chat. There we go.
There we go, that's better. How's that? All right, let's drop some liquid fertilizer here. Top left corner, you can see, or bottom left corner, you can see the nitrogen. And it automatically knows how much to put on the parsnips, so it should be perfect when we're done.
Hi, Frosty, I just downloaded the mod to Zend. Oh, yeah, speaking of the mod, the one I just posted, or not posted, the one I just showed you, I did put the link for it in my Discord, but that doesn't have, it doesn't hold 50,000 liters. I edited that myself. But I think the one I posted holds like 20-something thousand, which is still good. That's still 4 times better than the premium expansion capacity, because that one only held like what 5,500 liters or something horrible. So yeah, we'll have to do like 3 laps here, get this all covered. Yeah, this nasty texture though, not a fan. That's the one thing I'm not liking about the premium expansion. Something's bugged out. And it's weird because it doesn't do it on the entire field. Like, that edge of the field looks like it should look. So why did it not, like, you know what I mean? Like, and then parts of the edge here are not, I don't understand. I don't understand.
But yeah, that's the only thing I'm not liking, is that weird looking texture. All right, last swipe here. I got it on King's Mods. Yeah, that one holds 20-something thousand.
Get the party started. What's up, Miles?
And then gets rid of everything I did in XML's Mountain. I got in the XML for Alma, Missouri to get for cows, and when I load it back up, it wants to do an update.
Well, that's because you changed it. Just don't update it. Yeah, why would you update it? If you're changing it, you're changing it. So the game thinks you need to update it to get it to where it where the modder has it set to. So just don't update it, and it'll keep it the way yours is. That's how that works. Yeah, don't update it. Yep, that'll fix it. So whatever you did is going to show. But the minute you click update, it's just going to put it right back to the way it was before you changed something. So just don't update it. All right, Daddy? Easy peasy, right? All right, so spraying's done. I don't think there's anything else I got to do at the moment except skip to the next day. I think that was all we had to do. But let me double check. Let's just take a little gander here at the stuff. Chickens, I did have to top them off. They're full of food. They're good. Factories, look at this. So I finished the field we were working on whatever day that was, Thursday, I think. So we have 140,000 liters of carrots, 178,000 liters of parsnips. All that is going to be converted into soup. So when we skip over to the next month, we're going to have a crap load of soup, chat. And you know what that means. We're going to be rich. We're going to have some money. You heard? It's going to be nice. It's going to be real nice. All right. So what do we got going on here? We own these five fields. Look at that score, 87 on field 54. That's quite lovely. That's quite lovely right there. I love how it breaks it down, too. Tells you how much money you've put into that field and your total earnings. So field 54 has given us about $30,000 back. 53 has given us about 10 grand back. 52, we've done two harvests now on 52. It's given us almost 65 grand. On income. 76 has given us $86,000, and field 50 has been our worst at 7,200, but that's because we've only done one harvest on 50, and I can't remember what that was. I forget what that was in that field. I think it was wheat. And all that wheat is in our silo. That's why that one's so low, because we saved all the crop. We didn't sell it. So yeah, all in all, looking pretty good. All right, we're going to skip to the next day, chat. We're going to the month of January. You ready? Oh, I finally activated the stack mod that stacks the pallets. So we should have a crap load of pallets like all stacked up on each other, which is stinking sweet. All right, so we're going to sleep until 8 a.m. Till next month. I just drank like a 2-liter bottle of NyQuil. We're sleeping through a whole month, chat. Good evening, Jeremy Bashaw. What app is that? What app? Precision Farming. It's a mod, Precision Farming, if that's what you're talking about. All right, so we're in the month of January. And it looks like snow is in the forecast. Yes, it is. And I forgot I wanted to turn snow off. I mean, we can see it in the sky, but I don't really want it all over the ground. So I'm just going to turn that off real quick because we're not going to mess around with plowing and all that stuff. There we go. All right, so it'll disappear after we, there we go. Just disappeared right there. So it's still winter time, but I just didn't want snow all over the ground. All right, so month of January, we're gonna fast forward to about, we'll go to about 11 o'clock. That'll get some more stuff spawned in for us. And we'll also, yeah, have a little more sunlight too. All right, so welcome to the month of January. It's 11 a.m. in the morning. Turn it off in real life. You want it off in real life? What's up, Rabid Rob? That's why I haven't been able to play, says One Stack. I played Farm Sim today for the first time in like a month and a half or so. Did you? Did you get the, do you have the year two pass, one stack? It's been giving some people issues. I haven't had any like game breaking issues, but I've heard there's people that can't even load their game. The game crashes. Like there's some issues going on out there, which is sad to hear. So it kind of sucks. But here's our parsnips. They hatched. My parsnip eggs hatched, chat. My parsnip eggs. All right, so they sprouted. That is stage 2 of 4. Takes about 5 months for the new root crops. So that's looking good. Our sorghum is ready to harvest, so we are going to knock that out. We're going to get 123% yield on that. And then this should be soybeans. We got soybeans growing, but we do have weeds. So we are going to get the weeder hooked up ASAP and have a course play worker get rid of all these weeds for us. And then over here is our oat field, which is also ready to harvest. So we got some harvesting to do. We got 2 fields to knock out. And this is a perfect yield, 89% here. So yeah, we got work to do here. And we also got stuff to sell, money to make. Everything's good up in the hood. You feel me? All right, let's hook up the International to the weeder. We don't need much horsepower for that. And we'll get a hired worker killing those weeds for us, getting them pulled out with the weeder attachment. We got Bradley Simmons also dropping a gifted membership. Thank you very much, y'all. Got David Turville on the receiving end of that gifted membership. Thank you very much, Bradley, and congrats there, David Turville. David usually always watches, so he is super well-deserving of a gifted sub. Enjoy that, brother. And thank you for always watching. I appreciate you, sir. Thank you, Bradley. Bradley also dropping a $10 super chat with a heart. Didn't even have to say a word. He's just throwing that heart in. That's Bradley Simmons, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much, Bradley, as always, for the support. Thank you, buddy. Donald Snodgrass is in here. John Giblin, hello, Frosty. What's going on, John? I'm just getting ready to get some weeds knocked out here. Look how low my case tractor is on fuel. We're going to have to put in a... I think we need to invest in a fuel tank to keep... to put on our property. Because I have noticed... I'm running out of fuel a lot. Not running... it's just running low on most of my tractors. All right, what's this over here? This is my red beet. I don't think there's any weeds in this one. Well, this is ready to harvest, too. Oh, baby, we got red beet to harvest, chat. So we got red beet, oats, and sorghum all ready to harvest. Yeah, we're going to be busy. It's going to be a big harvesting night, which is always fun. Everybody loves harvesting. All right, like I said, we're going to get a hired worker going here. Let's do 2 headlands, sharp, clockwise. Start at first waypoint. Hopefully they don't run out of fuel. They might run out of fuel doing this. This is a pretty good sized field. All right, so I hired a worker. He's going to kill all the weeds for us. That'll be one thing knocked out in the background while we're doing other stuff. What's up, Brent Linderman? Hello. Farmers be harvesting cotton right now in my neck of the woods, is Joe Dirt. Come on. I ain't got no cotton on this map. Not yet. No. Hello, Brian Santor. Kevin Flores. Good evening. I got it. I had some freezing when hitting the back button in the start menu. That's normal with the premium. That's normal with an expansion because the whole game gets updated. So the best thing to do is delete your shaders folder. Not the whole folder. Go into your folder, delete the files inside your shaders cache, restart the game, load up the map, and run around the map, or if you can get into flight mode, just kind of go into flight mode and just fly around for a while, let everything render in, and then you should see a huge boost in performance. I wish they would just tell you that. They don't tell you that, but there's a little tip. There's a tip of the night chat. That's how you'll see a little boost in performance there. All right, so what should we harvest first? Do you guys want to see the new harvester in action, the pull behind? I feel like that definitely needs to get fired up first, right? So let's see that new harvester get put to work here on the red beat. It's a pretty nice machine. I'll do a couple headlands with it, and then we'll hire a worker. But it does a good job. And the hired workers use it great, too. Like, they know how to use it. It's good stuff. Oh, yeah. You know what? Let's put that fuel tank in. We got 16 grand. Let's put a fuel tank in on the farm, because this tractor's almost ran out of fuel also. And I really don't want to run out of fuel. So we need a container. We don't need nothing crazy. This one will be fine. Holds 5,000 liters of fuel. We can, like, shove it right here. Yeah, we'll just plop it. Boop. Right there. That looks good to me. What do you say? There we go. And then I'm also going to have to fill it up with some fuel. And I don't have to drive to the gas station every time my tractors are low. Alright, let's fill that up. $6,800. Jeez! Alright, that's fine. That's fine. We're going to need it. Alright, so that's ready to fill up. Bottom right corner, you'll see that green bar fill up. We got a full tank of fuel. There we go. That is nice. One less thing to worry about. What's up, Mike Stilts? Mike, how's everything going, Mr. Stilts? You doing all right? I know you had that crappy thing happen with the job last week. How'd that all plan out? Got everything taken care of and hopefully back to working, I hope. What's up, Joey Moriera? Hello, Pleasant Views. Says, howdy, Fisherman Frost. Did you see that? That was pretty sweet, wasn't it? That was a nice catfish I caught today. It was about 15 pounds. It was a good-sized catfish. Am I folded or unfolded? I need to unfold. There we go. All right, watch this thing go, chat. This thing's sweet. All right, so we're going to get it lowered. Get it activated. Like I said, it's got a 4-meter work width. Oh, yeah. Get them red baits going, daddy. Oh, so much nicer. So much nicer. Ah, that's so pleasant. Isn't that pleasant? Ah, so much. So better. I love it. All right, chat. Now that you know it works, you can hire a worker. All right, hired worker, get it done. Look at that nice work width on it, 4-meter work width. This is a steep hill, so it's going to struggle a little bit, but it's going to be just fine. That is going to get the job done so much quicker. We got Duane Baker also sending a gifted membership. Going to Jeremy Bashaw. Congratulations, Jeremy Bashaw. And thank you, Duane Baker, for the gifted membership. Thank you. Good evening, WH. What was your handle when you was trucking? Not many people ever called me anything, but when I hauled coal, sometimes they called me Wild Horse because I drove kind of fast, faster than I should have. I need some more real-life fishing with Frosty Shorts. You might. My son, he loves fishing, so we had a good day at the pond. That was a big pond. That had, like, some big catfish in it. I was surprised. But isn't that nice, chat? Is that not so much better than the premium expansion crap that they give you? This is so much better. What's up, Scooter's Workbench? Scooter, look at my harvester. 4 meter work width on this bad boy. And I made it able to hold 50,000 liters of all the new root crops. Oh, this is so much nicer. Oh, I love it. I love it! I really do. I really think it's nice. I like it a lot. Whew! Alright, what else we got going on here? I had to break down and buy a fuel tank too. Was just eating through the fuel. I know. The gas... I don't like going to the gas station. So we invested in a fuel tank over there. And now I don't have to worry about my tractors running out. However, the farm all might run out of fuel. All right, I'm going to dismiss him for a minute. I'm going to go around this corner up here because that utility pole might be a problem. So we're going to take care of that real quick. Just going to do like a swipe or two back and forth along this part. Just so the hired worker has room to turn around and stuff. Catfish nuggets. Yeah, they were like blue catfish. They were pretty cool looking. They're kind of pretty. When you think of a catfish, you don't think of it being pretty. But it kind of looked pretty. The blue tint it had to its skin, it looked nice. It was a nice looking fish. Yeah, we caught about 6 of them total altogether. You know what? I might do one more pass. Just want that hired worker to have room to operate. There we go. We're not even at 50% yet. Love it. Good evening, Frosty. How you doing tonight? Hope you're having a good night. What's up, Daniel Ricard? I'm having a good night, and I hope you're having a good night, and I am having a good night. Thank you very much for asking if I had a good night, because I am. There you go. What's up, Dakota Stevenson? You guys aren't going to like me. I don't like it. We're not going to like you. Why? Two more to be safe, says doing. Yeah, I think back and forth. So that's, what, 4 passes? That should be plenty to get turned around. Oh, yeah. Very nice. And if you, for those that are in my Discord or want to join and you want to find more mods that handle the new root crops, Adam Hank, he found one by, well, Miss Mountain in the chat. Mountain and Adam Hank. The NF Marsh Harvester edited. That's another one you can use. And then I posted one yesterday that I think I have activated. I can show it to you guys in the store here in a minute. It's another option. And it's pretty much the Grimmy or the Ropa, the big drivable ones that can handle the new crops also. So all the info for that's in my Discord. But yeah, this thing's sweet. It's really nice. Where's the pipe on this bad boy? I don't want to unfold my pipe. Oh, I think we gotta wait till it's like full, which it's gonna be a while. Struggling on the hill, but other than that, thing's doing very good job. You're a picky eater. I'm having a good night, getting ready to go to work soon. Come on! Hit that like button, says Aaron Ashlock. That's right, hit it. You know that 4 meter harvester exceeds the Polish map requirements by a meter or so. Oh well. This was desperately needed, Scooter. And you know it. Alright, I think you guys see that this is working beautifully. So we're gonna let it keep doing its thing. We got other things we gotta continue working on here. So let's go fire up the harvester. Which at some point I'd like to sell this and trade it in, but no rush. It still gets the job done. Top this off with some fuel also. I squeeze through here. Top off the fuel tank. Good to go there. Get her unfolded. And actually, I want to start on the oats. Let's go to that oat field first, because we can drop the swath and make some bales. Get a little, we'll see. We'll see where our finances are. I do want to have cows eventually. Or some other type of animal other than chickens. So we might save whatever straw bales we make this time around. AI worker nearly has a full tank of red beets over there, so he will need emptied soon. He's going to have a total of 50,000 liters. He's turning around, but down there. And he made that turn, chat. All right, he made that turn without hitting the utility pole, so we did that perfectly back there. But he'll keep doing his thing. All right, let's see. Swather. I think the swather is already open. So I think we're good. Let's see what happens. Nope. I guess it's not. Make sure that's closed. All right, now we should be good. Now we should be dropping a swath. There we go, very nice. Beautiful. So bringing in the oats now. I'm doing good, John Williams. My Monday's going splendid, Jeremy Qualm. Have you seen the new combine that's only a cab and header? I think so. I think I've seen that. It's huge, isn't it huge too? Like it's massive. I think I've seen videos of that, if that's the one I'm thinking you're talking about. Hey, Frost, you just got here spending time with my brother. Hope you're doing well. What's up, Clunkamo? We're harvesting. We got a lot of harvesting to do tonight. We got oats, sorghum, red beets, deliveries. We'll be selling some soup at some point. Yeah, it's going to be real nice. All right, so we're going to leave this guy alone. I think our red beet is already full. So we're going to fire up the Iveco and trailer. Get this thing ready for some business. Get us some red beet. Right. What's up, Rhett? Mr. Akers. Good evening, Frosty and chat. Hello there. I hope you're doing well, Mr. Akers. Rhett did a live stream over the weekend. I stopped in there for a little bit. Mr. McKinley did a live stream on Saturday night or something, I think. Tried to stop into both of them and show some support, just like they do for me all the time. Oh, jeez. Got a little too close there. So you just want to get to the edge of the pipe, and there you go. Red beet galore, chat. 50,000 liters. It's going to take a little while to unload all that. I'll drive one of your grain trucks for you, Frost. You better watch your mouth, David. All right? I'm kidding. We'll see. Ian W., how you doing, brother? How's Australia treating you? How's the weather in Australia right now? Is it still cold? Is it still winter time over there? Or is it getting nice again? You're at a Coyotes and Kings hockey game. Well, have a good time there. That sounds fun. Yeah, this thing is going to have 50,000 liters in it when we come back. We're not even half. Yeah. It's going to be a minute before this harvester is empty. I love it, though. It saves so much time. What's up, Fent Farmer? Good evening, good evening. Watch the paint. Yeah, we scratched it. Scratched a little bit. Scoot over, fill up that rear end there a little bit. But I think this trailer, I can't remember how much this trailer holds. But I think it can't hold whatever this holds. I think the trailer does like 40-something thousand. But isn't that beautiful? I love it. I just love it. Fent, you, Joshua Hoffman, I forget, there's all kinds of people playing Call of Duty with me over the weekend. Thanks for everybody who tuned into the Pew Pew channel. We did a stream Saturday night. I think it was Saturday night. Yeah, there you go. So this holds 48,000 liters. So the harvester still has 2,000 in it, but it's still going to be going for a while. Look at that, chat. Oh, is that beautiful or what? Oh, yeah. Put that tarp on and take it on down to the soup factory. It's late spring going on summer and upside down Ozland, I think. It's late spring. I'll drive it like it's never been driven before. Oh, really? Oh, really? Hello, Fred Murphy. How are ya? All right, so 48,000 liters of red beet heading to the soup factory. I was thinking about getting the preserved food factory, but we're not going to think about buying that until we've got, like, a full soup factory. If we have, like, a ton of leftovers, maybe we'll invest in the preserved food factory. Excuse me. Goodness. I played better with y'all then when it's just me, says Dakota. Oh, Dakota was there. I'm just horrible with memory. I know it was Joshua Hoffman. Levi Schultz, he was there. Bent Farmer. Oh, William Bone and myself. So there's five. We almost had a full six-man team playing Call of Duty. We did all right. I'd say we won 50% of our matches, which to me is all right. Not bad.
Thanks for the sub.
Is that Harvester on console or PC? PC. It's an edited version of the one that's already in the game. Yep, PC. Here. Okay, why is my soup factory not stacking the pallets? I thought it would stack them. Isn't that what the stack pallet mod does? Or maybe it just doesn't work with the new stuff yet? Maybe that's the problem. All right, but here we are at the soup factory. We're going to dump all 48,000 liters of red beet in here. Very nice. Delicious. That looks really good. All right, how much we got in here? All right, so red beet's back up to 48,000. We can actually activate red beet soup again now that we have some red beets. So we have three different soups being made. All we need to do is, like, buy a planter that can do potatoes and get a potato field put in down the road, and then we can combine all of these and make triple soup, which is worth a lot of money. Oh, look at that. Look at that variety pack we got going here. So what's that? Parsnip soup? Ugh, sounds so gross. Carrot soup? So this is a mix of parsnip and carrot soup, and there's a lot of it ready to spawn. Good Fozzie, thanks, mate. What's up, Fozzie? Fozzie Gaming, hello there. I just delivered me a big load of red beet. I think my other harvester is ready to be emptied. So we'll hit that up. What we'll do is unload that harvester, the green harvester, and we'll just dump all that into the silo at the house, since it's kind of hard to do both at the same time.
That'll save up time for the red beat so we can get that delivered. All right, one more bridge. I always turn too early. Second bridge, make a right, and that takes us back to the house. Right there. Guy pulled right out in front of me, didn't he? He's like, I don't care. I don't need to stop for you. Good evening, Matthew Vow. We got Clonkamo dropping a $5 super chat. Says, I don't know what your schedule is like this week, but I'm sure the food will be good. I rarely have time with them, so I'm loving being here. Clonkamo, I'm glad you get to spend some good time with your brother. Enjoy it, and don't worry about me, that's for sure. Don't worry about watching the show. You go hang out with him and have a good time, all right? Enjoy hanging out with family. But yeah, I'll be here. I should be here every day but Thanksgiving Day. All right, is he full? Oh, I don't want to unload him. I want to unload the other guy. He's kicking butt, though. He's almost done. Look how quick! Do you guys realize we spent like over an hour or more harvesting this field with the premium expansion harvester? Do you remember how painful that was last week? Look at this guy. He's almost done. We started this like, what, 10 minutes ago? And he's almost done with the entire field. Like, how nice is that? And this guy's almost done too. Let's get all the oats out of here.
Thank you.
Get things done. I think our weed remover worker, he got all the weeds out of that green field there. So that's another chore that's done. You made spaghetti for dinner? Nice. Doing good and happy. Have had bowling since Saturday and made an average of 216, 4 on 12. Man. So Fozzie is a serious bowler, Chad. That is an awesome average. The max score you can get bowling is 300. He's averaging 216 a game. That's pretty stinking good there, sir. That's very, very good. Dang. I love bowling too, but I ain't that good. Those are some good numbers there. That a nice. All right, we are going to have a little issue here because I have a trailer blocking my silo. So we'll have to get that out of the way. Good evening, Mike Alamendinga. Spring is ending and it is starting summer. It's 76 degrees. Ah, nice. That's about, well, today was like 67, 68 degrees, which I love. This is my favorite time of the year. I love this fall weather. Love it. All right, let's get this trailer out of here, out of the way. Could actually use this to cart the oats back and forth. But for now, we'll just sit it here. All right. Get this dumped. $8,500 liters of oats. Not bad. One load from the harvester. I made steak, mixed vegetables, rice, and salad for dinner. Tastes quite all right also. Not bad. I didn't really have anything. Because here's how my day went. I took my son and his friend fishing. And I kind of crunched time a little. We got some McDonald's, which I'm not a fan of. But we grabbed it because I brought him home.
And he had enough time to run upstairs, put on his basketball clothes for practice, grab his basketball shoes, hop right back in the car, and I had to take him to school for practice. So there was no chance to have a sit-down dinner at home anyway. It was just one of those type of days.
Nice-looking fish you caught. That was nice, wasn't it, Mr. Almendinger? It was about a 15-pound catfish, a blue catfish. Very nice.
Rhett, go have fun at that hockey game. Thank you very much for stopping in, sir. Enjoy your evening as well. It was 40 this morning here in Ohio, says Pat. It's 28 in upstate New York. Whew! That's where I gotta go in about a month for Christmas. Heading up to Ohio again to see family. And I'm sure it's gonna just be cold and horrible as usual. Painful. I used to love bowling, and I had a 200 average before I hurt my ankle. 15 pounds, I didn't see it. It's in the Discord. Or no, I made a short. I made an actual YouTube short, Kevin. Anybody watching right now can easily go watch the fish I caught. And I even acted like a crazy person like I normally am. So if you want to see how I act with my son and when his friends are around, you can go watch that short right now. I uploaded it today. How was his game from last Friday? They lost, but he played hard. He played hard. And then over the weekend, my daughter had her first YMCA volleyball game. She ended up winning her game, so she was super excited. Yeah, it was a nice weekend. Been feeling good at the lanes? I would say so. Sounds like the bowling ball's on fire there, Falsey. That's a very, very good average, 216. Please. All right, so another 48,000 liters heading out. Looks like we'll have just one more load. So only three loads to the soup factory compared to who knows how many loads we were taking last week. Like three loads, that ain't nothing. I'm fine doing three loads. This is like a vacation compared to last week, all those deliveries we had to make. So yeah, this is nice. Where is that short? YouTube. This is YouTube, Joshua. YouTube short, you know? YouTube. Come on, Joshua. Come on. Come on, Mr. Hoffman. Didn't get a notification for the short. I just posted it today. Who knows? I don't know. But it's there. Yeah. Just go to my shorts section. You'll see it. All right. These people pulling out in front of me. I'm about to rip them a new one. I'm about to rip them a new one, chat. Come on. They need to get like some type of stop and go thing going like people do in real life where you stop, not just pull out like I'm about to do right here. You know? Come on. Stop, AI. Rabid Rob coming in with a $10 super sticker says level up. Thank you very much, Rabbit Rob. Ah, that guy pulled out in front of me too! He's rabid. Thank you very much for the $10 super chat, sir. Always appreciate the support from you. Thank you very much, sir. We appreciate it. I'm going in this way this time. I always go in the other way. Let's go in the opposite way. That tarp off. 48,000 liters of red beet getting ready to be dumped. We might max this factory out. No, we won't. No, we won't. Never mind. I forgot. Red beet was empty, so this is all fresh. But yeah, there'll be plenty of room for more. There we go.
Thank you.
And once we get all the harvest done, we'll be heading over here to sell all the soup. And it should be quite a good crap load of soup. Should have quite a bit. Red Van just committed insurance fraud. I know. Did you see that? Yes. I just watched it. Good work, Frost. Did you see that, Metro? Going in on console mod hub, they have street lights you can place. It helps. Street lights you can place. Sean Bright, what are you talking about? Street lights? What do I need street lights for? Eh. Frosty, the catfish video was hilarious. I'd love to see more in real life videos. There you go. Yeah, it was fun. It was fun. It was a good one. It was fighting, too. It did not want to be brought up to the surface at all. So, it was fun. My son got a good laugh out of it. You good, Tony?
Good.
Kyle Walters also coming in with the gifted membership. You guys are sending lots of memberships tonight. I appreciate that. We got one Big Rig Frosty Gaming membership from Kyle Walters going to Floyd Stutinger. Congratulations, Floyd. And thank you, Kyle Walters. Thank you so much, guys. I do appreciate it. Hope you guys are enjoying episode 3 here. Things are going to move along so much better now with the upgraded equipment. All right, let's unload the oat harvester. He's probably ready to be unloaded. Where is he parked at? He's way down yon. He's way. You know what? He's done. He's done with the field. We can just empty him by bringing him back to the house. Here's the rest of the red beet. Done. The field is done already, chat.
Yeah, baby.
I love it. It's beautiful. Makes me very happy. All right, we got 17,000 liters left over here. Pipe out. The rest unloaded here. How nice was that? Now that's how you can enjoy root crops on Farm Sim. Don't feel like you have to be... I guess if you're on console, you are kind of screwed. But if you're on PC, stop torturing yourself. Get some of these mods that makes the premium expansion actually fun, okay? You will not be disappointed. It'll actually be fun, Chad, I promise. Is this map on console or is it on PC only? Tony, this is the premium expansion DLC. So, yes, it's for console and PC, yes. You looked a little constipated reeling that fish. They turn red when you drive by at AI stops. Frosty, I bet you will get more views if you keep on doing that. Oh, I don't care about that. I don't care about that part. But no, I figured you guys would just like seeing the catfish. All right, let's go get this sprayed off. There is no more root crops to harvest at the moment, at least not for the month of January. But yeah, how about that machine there, baby? I'll tell you what. That's right. Get her done. So much better. And I'm hoping we can have enough money selling soup to possibly... See, I don't know what I want to do next. I don't know. I feel like a bakery would be a good investment for our other crops like oats, wheat, barley, so we can make bread and have another production profit. But the other part wants to get into the whole piano manufacturing. But the only way to make that work is a lot of money invested. We would need to buy the sawmill so that we can make planks. And then we'd need to buy the manufacturing piano place. And all that adds up to a lot of money that we don't have. So I don't know. I don't know if it's even possible tonight. So I might go ahead and do the bakery route. We might buy the bakery tonight. I think we'll have more than enough money to do that. Kevin Flores coming in with the $10 super chat. Says, wow, Frosty. I'm not sure what was more shocking. The size of the fish or the pink chair you were sitting in before you caught it. Nice catch. That is not 15 pounds, though. Get in my belly. My son had a little weigher. He has a little weigh machine that tells you exactly what they weigh. Saying he caught a 10 pounder, I caught a 15 pounder, and they caught another like 9 pound, 11 pound. They were all like between 10 and 15 pounds. They were pretty heavy. I don't know if it's just what they were eating, but yeah, that's what the weight said. I'm just saying, I wasn't trying to blow any smoke. Night Frosty, very busy work. All right, Donald, get your butt out of here. What's this farm called? Zielonka. That is what it's called. Zielonka. All right, so he's ready to rock and roll. Thank you very much, Kevin, for the $10 super chat. Kyle Walters also for the gifted membership. Thank you, guys. All right, I need to get that guy that was picking weeds. Get him out of here. Get him put away. And he needs fuel. This is the farm all tractor. He's sitting at like a quarter tank. We need to get some fuel in his belly. Did y'all? Yeah, we throw them all back. Yeah. We always do catch and release. He just enjoys fishing. We just catch him, throw him back. But yeah, he loves it. He could have been there all day if it wasn't for basketball practice. He probably would have wanted to stay till it got dark out. All right, so we'll get this topped off with fuel, spray it all down, and park it up. Yeah, this was the tractor that was closest to running out of fuel. Very nice. Full tank now. Beautiful. Amen on the new mod. So much better to harvest root crops. Thanks for the find. Did you see the... oh, yeah. I wanted to show you guys. I think it's all the way at the bottom. I got a few mods. You know what I'm saying? I don't know where it is. I know it's activated. It's probably under... Nope. There. Right there. The Rexer 6300. All right. So the in-game one is the Rexer 6300 Platinum. This is the Rexer 6300 Platinum edited. See any difference here? Game one does beets. Sugar beets. Look at this one. This one does sugar beets, red beet, carrots, and parsnips. Right here, baby. Very nice. And it also holds 45,000 liters. And I think it has like a 3 or 4 meter work width on it. But that's a self-propelled one. So another nice option there. And I did put the link for that in my Discord under FS22 mod links or something like that. That's another option too. We have a fishing team at the high school. Ooh, my son would love if there was an actual fishing team at school. But he did join that fishing club, so he loves being a part of that. Beef and ham are not the same. Tastes good, though. They both taste real nice. What's up, Dave Fowler? Who else? Helper on the high-end harvester. I run the trailer. It's not that bad. No crop destruction on, though. All right, so this is all sprayed up, full tank of fuel. Bada bang, bada boom. I shouldn't have any more weeds to deal with. That should be good. Let's go deliver this final load of red beet.
And that'll be it for the red beef. Then when we get back, we'll get the harvester over there emptied, get the oats out of it, get it started on the sorghum field. And while that's going on, we will start working on making the square straw bales. So yeah, we definitely stay busy tonight, and a nice variety of things to do too. Get your subs in, Chad. I sent that like an hour ago. Busy man says clunkamo. I'll still meet though. No, I really. Justin Abeta, thank you for the $5 super chat. Says, what is up, Frosty? Can finally watch a game. Soft ball is over. Yeah. Softball should be over. Should Tony Martig, is he in the chat? Is softball over for you yet? Yeah, I imagine any outdoor sports is probably coming to an end here for most of us. Thank you, Mr. Abeta. How'd the softball season go? Do you have any home runs? I was never a home run hitter. Like, every once in a while, I'd get lucky and get a hold of one. But I gave up on trying to go for the fence. I just more of a place hitter. I'd try to hit it out in right field and get a double if I could get a double out of it, you know? Yeah, I never had that deep ball hit with the playing softball and stuff.
Thank you.
I just don't have that upper strength, that upper brute strength, I guess. All right, here's our final load of red beet to the soup factory. Fish near a power plant dam, and you will catch some big kites.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, this was a pond. Those were some big catfish for a pond. It wasn't a lake. It was like an actual pond. It was good. We went undefeated, and yes, about 10. Whew, Mr. Beta got some pythons. He's like, I eat my spinach. And I hit home runs regularly. Undefeated with about 10 home runs. That's sounds like he's a good ball player, chat. All right, we are going to fill up the truck with some fuel. About a quarter tank low. Have to pay for it. But. $127. That's cheap. And Rhett, I did find the golden egg you were talking about that was over by the blue tarp. I did find that one. Rhett posted all kinds of photos of where some of the golden eggs were that he found. Or golden apples. They're golden apples, right? Yeah, golden apples is what I meant, not golden egg.
There are golden apples on this map. Collectibles, 5,000 apiece if you can find them.
I think we've found close to 20 of them. And there's 50 of them hiding around. But yeah, that's awesome. 10 jacks.
What's up, Ice Dragon?
I keep missing that one little dirt. There's like a little dirt road that I keep going by that brings me up to the other end of my field here. So let's go get a harvester emptied. And then we'll send him over to the sorghum field to harvest. There you go. Got about 3,600 liters left over in here. There we go. Dave is watching Monday Night Football, Philadelphia Eagles versus the Kansas City Chiefs.
Very nice. Well, I hope you enjoy it.
Hello, Frosty. How you doing from Carter and I? What's up, Mr. Culbertson?
Hope you guys are doing well. I am doing splendid. Thank you for asking.
Just getting ready to hit the sorghum field here. I can't see a darn thing in first person view.
You got me wanting to go camping this weekend to catch some kites.
I do like camping this time of year, too. I don't know if we'll be able to squeeze a camping trip in with basketball practice. Like, it's almost impossible. But yeah, this is a great time of the year to do some camping.
All right, we got an empty tank. It's ready to fill with some sorghum.
Get him working here. We'll do two headlands, blah, blah, blah. That'll be good. First waypoint. Bada bing, bada boom.
All right, so he's going to knock out sorghum for us.
Keep the good times rolling on the harvest here.
You're having a hot dog.
We used hot dog for bait today. We went through two packs of hot dogs.
How's it going, Frosty? Can I have the usual, please? Well, I don't know. I haven't seen you in ages. I feel like I should give you more of one of these.
Lester. How you doing, buddy? Here's your honk-a-tooter.
How the heck are you, sir? I didn't know if you were still alive and kicking. It's been so long.
Hope you're doing well, though, buddy.
All right, let's go drop the oats. So what do you think, chat? You think we should buy the bakery tonight?
Because we could get the bakery up and running.
Or no, we wouldn't be able to. We'd need... dang it, I didn't even think of that. We'd need the grain mill to make flour. Ugh.
I totally forgot about that. Yeah, we would need to purchase a grain mill before we could do, make bread.
Dang it. Yeah, I wasn't thinking about that. Is there even a grain mill to buy on this map? I'll have to check. I don't know if there is or not.
Hey, Frosty, do you have any tutorial videos on how to do productions? I do not. I don't. But there's a lot of them out there. But yeah, me personally, I don't. Sorry, buddy.
Hey, Frosty, how are you and the fam doing? It's been cold here. I heard everybody's getting some chilly weather. Getting a little chilly out there for you guys.
I'm doing good. Thank you for asking.
Ah, I'm sorry to hear that, Lester.
Yeah, I didn't even know, buddy. We haven't heard from you, so I didn't know how things were going for you.
I'm sorry to hear that, sir. I'm very sorry to hear that.
What's up, Mr. Anthony Wilson? I caught a fish with a piece of pancake.
Fish will almost eat anything. They like all kinds of stuff. But yeah, never heard of anybody catching one with a pancake.
If we could ban ourselves, who would do it?
If you could ban yourself?
I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. It's kind of odd. Why anybody would do that. Anyways,
what was I doing? What am I doing? I'm looking for productions here, chat.
So let's see here on the map. I don't know if we can purchase the grain mill or not. So I'm gonna visit it real quick. I just wanna see if it's purchasable. So far, not seeing trigger point to activate it. Like a buy or sell not buy or sell, but you know what I mean. Like, I don't know. Maybe you can't own this this one. Anybody know? I don't think you can. That would be a real jackwhacker move. What you say you fish with? I catch mine with chicken livers. We use that sometimes, Joe. But today we used hot dogs. The catfish were loving it. They were biting like crazy. What's up, Zach Ryan? What am I doing for Thanksgiving? We're having friends over, having it at the house this year. Good evening, Bedrock. So I guess there's no way to purchase this grain mill. That sucks. Is there another one on the map? Piano manufacturer, supermarket, farmer's market, soup factory, dairy, spinnery, preserved food factory, animal dealer, carpentry, sawmill, debris crusher. That kind of sucks. Is it still going to make flour for us? Ah, that sucks. All right, so that kind of scratches the whole bakery plan. I guess we're not going to be having a bakery. We're not going to be making bread. So that's fine. That's fine. So I don't really know what else there is to do with the other type of crops other than sell them outright, which, you know, that never pays a whole lot. Kind of sucks. That kind of sucks, Giant. Can I buy the dairy? Or, like, I feel like we can only visit these places. We can't buy them. Why would they do that? I don't understand. Like, what's the point? Just make it purchasable. This is weird. All right, so I guess you can't buy the dairy. You can't buy... Why? Why do that? That's so odd to me. Is that odd to you? Does that make you guys wonder, like, why? That doesn't make sense to me. All right, he's got a full grain tank full of sorghum already. Let's get him unloaded. I don't know why they would do that. Happy Thanksgiving given to you and all the wonderful chat. Right back at you, Lester. Right back at you, laddie. Yeah, I'm excited for Thanksgiving. Always a nice holiday. Oh, I forgot to do the stinking flipping stop for loading crap. All right, 1 second, chat. I gotta change the settings. Stop while unloading, activated. There we go. There we go. That should be good. Can you buy the land the grain mill is on? Maybe that's how it all works. You might be onto something there. That's probably is. Yeah, you're probably right. And I don't have that much money. But that might be what has to be done. No. Nope. It doesn't let you buy it. That's, yeah, nope. That sucks, huh? So you can't buy the land it's on to own it, and you can't purchase that production. So this kind of is what it is, I guess, huh? This kind of is what it is. All right, what's going on? We need to start bailing, chat. And we also need to figure out what we're going to do with this field right here. It does need some lime, but I'm not going to put lime on it quite yet. I need to figure out what's going on with these stinking, those textures. Oh. We'll get the ridge. Yeah, we'll get the ridge maker hooked up and ready to roll. Yep, you can't buy it. You're right. Just can't do it. It's the way the cookie crumbles. The government will even help you in FS22. They will. I'm just going to place my own next to the grain mill. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if I want to do all that money. We'll see. We'll see. Might have to, huh?
Elizabeth Sturdy, thank you for the 10 pounds. Says, I did ask if you had found any more golden apples.
But missed your reply.
Whilst I was on my way up here to bed. Loved your fishing short.
Does your son ever need any help with landing his fish? No, actually, he let me reel that one in. Because he had just caught one. And then he puts like four... I think today he had three or four poles all going at the same time. Like, he doesn't just do one. So he had four lines going. And the one started tugging. He's like, Dad, that's yours. You reel that one in. So that's the big one I reeled in there. But yeah, he does it all. He switches the hooks. He changes the lures. He does it all. He loves it. Thank you very much, Elizabeth, for the 10 pounds. Do appreciate you. I can't remember. Do I need to cultivate first, or can I just start putting the ridges in here? Guess we'll find out. Guess we'll find out right here, right now. Because I don't know. Yeah. I think you do have to cultivate it first. Dang it. Alright. It looks like we gotta cultivate it first. I'm just gonna place it. Alright, it's the way the cookie crumbles. How much is the bakery in this game? Not the bakery, the grain mill. Pretty pricey, isn't it? They have a placeable bakery, which is dumb. There's already a bakery that you can... Oil mill, sugar mill. So grain mill is 96 grand. If we placed our own grain mill down. It's not too bad. That's not too... Maybe we will put one down. We'll see. We'll just have to wait and see. I don't know. These decisions are just overwhelming. I don't know what to do. Very overwhelming for me. Sometimes it's too hard to handle the overwhelmingness of it. This is really hard. All right, let's fold this up, head over to that red beet field we knocked out. We got to get it cultivated before we can do the ridge. The ridging. Hello, stopping in real quick. What's up, Tony? We were just talking about you. We were talking about softball. I was like, I wonder if Tony's softball season is over. Because Corey, he went undefeated with 10 home runs. How was your final stats of the year, Tony, huh? What was your batting average? All right, let's get this guy hired. He should be fine. Yep, so that's all. It needed cultivated before we could do the ridge lines. Very nice. What's this guy up to? 66%. Oh, we still gotta do some straw bales, don't we? Ever show anyone your honey? Hopping in. Hey, Tony. All right, so we'll let him go, and we gotta get baling. I forgot all about that. We'll hook the Fiat up to the baler. See, that's the other thing. I was thinking about other animals, but I don't know if we're ready for other animals yet. I just don't think it's time. Because I was thinking I could maybe plant some grass.
in a field and think about making some silage bales. Or splitting the field, like half of it's silage, like half of it wrapped bales, half of it hay bales. But then I'm gonna need all, you know, I'm gonna need all that different equipment. I don't know what to do. I just don't know. It's just so much to think about. All right, you know what? He's ready to be emptied. Let's get him first. Softball's over. Been over for a couple weeks now, but I don't know what my average was. I'm kidding. I didn't think you kept track. Frosty, you jackwacker, you should just place a windmill grain mill that Oda... I know. I was going to not use modded productions on this series, but it's possible I could throw down that one, yes. And it would look nice, too. It'd actually look good on this map. Question is, I don't know if I even have it activated because I wasn't gonna use it. But it might be out there. I don't know. I might have it activated. If that's the case, I could just shove that on my own property somewhere. Yes, sir. I'm getting a good amount of sorghum out of here. I just hate to have... I don't want to sell the oats and the sorghum. I don't want to just sell it outright. Like, I want to be able to put it into some type of production. That's what I was hoping to do. Let me see if I have... See, now you got me curious. See if I have it active. Yeah, see, I don't have it active. Because I didn't think I was going to use it at all. So, yep, that's not even active. So, if we did it, we would just use the in-game one, which is... I don't know. Because, see, it might be worth backing out and activating that, because that's the one that also does the oils. Kind of hard to pass up, you know? Makes oils and flour. All right, let's make some bales. Unfold. Lower. And activate. Let's reset our baler. Trying to remember how to do that. Right control M. All right. So we've made 16 bales on this series so far. Now we're making a fresh batch right here on our oat field. You just need the seed auger and seed treatment. Seed auger and seed treatment. What about putting the oats in a cereal factory? Because I don't have honey. I don't have all the other, raisins and all that. I don't have all that crap. All I got is oats. Not a bad idea. I don't have all the other stuff that would be needed. You know what I mean? Kevin Flores, go Kansas City. Is Kansas City winning? Yeah, so we might... How about this? Once the sorghum harvest is done, and I'm done baling this, we'll do a hard save, and we'll just back out and activate the old grain mill mod, because it is a nice mod. And it's affordable, too. I don't know. What do you think, chat? Who cares, right? I don't know. I think with having easy economy on, when we sell this soup, we're going to have so much money. I don't know. I think we should punish ourselves and just buy the in-game factory. Did I see your message? Which one? Elizabeth, which one? I don't see any messages. I did see your super chat that I just read.
and thanked you for. Is that what you're talking about? Because other than that, I do not. I see a whole bunch of chat, and I don't see anything from you other than the super chat that I just got done reading. And I did say thank you, and I do appreciate it. Thank you very much, Elizabeth. Do it. What do it as in what? Do it. What am I doing? Am I getting the in-game one, or am I saving, backing out, activating the other one? What am I doing? You know what I mean? What are you doing? You know you want to activate the mod. It's killing us not to do it. So you want me to disactivate the mod? Okay. Back out. You must do it, says Josh. You must do it. It is crucial that you do it. All right. Can't say no to that. Josh is yelling at me. Okay, Ian, I'll just do it. Activate the other one. All right. Back out and get fine. All right, we only got a couple swipes of this. And I bet you the sorghum harvest. Yep, sorghum's all done. Beautiful. I'll pop those bales out. Let's go. Such a skinny little swath. If you're thinking too hard, just back out and get it. I will. Let me finish bailing, okay? Calm down, boys. Calm down. Backing out, save the money to get the mod. All right, Nikki. You guys are really, 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 yeah. Hey, Frosty, I downloaded a game called House Slipper. I think you would really, I've played that, Dustin. Trust me, been there, done that. Those were some of my longest streams I've ever done. There's a new one coming out, and I'm sure I'll break down and get that when it comes out. And we'll all suffer together. What mod, says Kevin? The old grain mill, the one we use on the survival series, the one that spins and it makes oil and flour, and it also makes like pig food mix, I think. Yeah, it's a good mod. It's kind of a cheating. It's definitely a cheat. It's like 15 grand to place the whole factory. So that part of it kind of feels like you're cheating, but... All right, let's unload this. All right, baling's all done. We just knocked out 11 bales in that field. Not too shabby. Get this brought back to the house. Slow down. Oh, I gotta speed up. Gotta keep things moving on this series. You know what I'm saying? I had to hammer down. All right, that should be it for bailing tonight. I don't think we'll... Yeah, I know we won't be bailing anything else, so... That sprayed off. Using the wind and great wisdom of old is not cheating. It's true. I guess it's however you want to look at it, right? Taylor Swift is always at his games. Oh, the Chiefs? Yeah. Where did I have this parked? I had it right over by the grain. Yeah, right over by the silo. Right. go. Get the harvester emptied. That is a finished harvest. What's going on here? There we go. Got about 2,200 liters left in here. Get that knocked out. Hello, Mr. Frosty. It's been a while since I've been able to catch a stream. Hope you're doing well. I am doing splendid, sir. Yeah, I've been enjoying the new premium expansion map, Zilunka. Have you tried it yet, Mr. SimStation? And I hope you're doing well also, sir. Thanks for stopping in. Appreciate you, mate. Yeah, I like it. Nice little map. Drop that right where it's at. Get her folded. And a magical spray down. All right, so I've got 19,000 liters of sorghum. I got about 10,000 liters of oats. All that is going to be put into our grain mill. I gotta back out and activate it because I totally forgot. See how this guy's doing. Oh, look at that. Perfect. He just finished his job. Got that field cultivated. We're just getting everything done here. I'll tell you what. Get her done. I have not. It looks great, but I'm nervous to purchase, but seeing a lot of people are having issues. I know. I keep hearing all the issues, too. Me, personally, I haven't had any game-breaking issues, but I have heard people having them. So, yeah, I don't blame you on that. Isn't that weird, though? Like, some people have the issues, but some don't. It's, like, random. But yeah, it's worked pretty good for me. There's things I don't like, that's for sure. The textures of the, like after you harvest and then you cultivate and then you use the ridge maker and then you go to plant one of the new root crops again, it makes this wacky looking texture. That's probably the thing I least like out of it all. But I'm hoping that's a bug that maybe they're gonna fix. I don't know. And the equipment is pointless. I've already purchased a modded version of the pull-behind harvester that was already in the game. Because the ones they give you for the expansion, they're a nightmare. They have like a 0.08 work width, and only one of them has a fill. Like, the other ones, you can't even fill them up. You have to drive beside them to unload them. And nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't right? Come on. All right, we're going to do a hard save, chat. Save it. Quit game. That's just going to take us back to the main menu.
What's up, Paul Edward Detweiler? Hello, sir. Have you tried the Storage Wars game again?
I have not. They have not done an update, so therefore it's still broken.
If I see they do an update, I might try it again, but no, they haven't. And I don't know if they'll... I don't know. All right, so all we're doing really is hitting continue and old... Probably going to be under O, old grain mill. HIJKLMNOP.
Where's O?
There it is, old grain mills. And load it back up.
Now that's just sad the KC cheerleaders aren't noticeable.
Really? Have you tried? What's up? I'm doing good, Paul. How you been? Haven't seen you in a while either, sir. Hope you're doing splendid.
(Clears
I think the only thing I like from the premium expansion as far as equipment goes is the Fiat. The Fiat tractor is pretty awesome. It sounds good, looks good, interior's nice. And I like the map. The map is nice. Other than that, all the other equipment's just kind of, eh. Probably never going to use barely any of it. Which sucks, because the self-propelled harvester looks awesome, but it doesn't hold anything. You have to drive beside it. But it looks cool. Just can't use it because it's, you know. Alright, so I'm thinking the grain mill can maybe be put over. I mean, can I place the grain mill? Yeah, I can. We did it on the other map. Yeah, I can place it on land that I don't own and it still works. So since it has to do with this area of the grain, that's the in-game grain mill that can't be purchased, how about we place the old grain mill, like, right over here? So I'm gonna just kind of smooth things out here. We're gonna level it's a little area here so we don't have any issues with it. We're gonna soften the edges here. It's not very big. You guys have seen it on the survival series. All right, productions. So we got this one. They're both the same, right? Old grain mill. Old American grain mill. Let's just do the old grain. Oh, I need money. We need to go sell soup first. I forgot about that. We got to go sell some soup, chat. I'm going to need my truck. We got to go sell my soup. I have not yet, Dakota. I have not. It looks interesting, though. Yeah, I forgot we need to go grab my other trailer, go sell some soup so we have money to do anything. There we go. All right, let's roll. I'm loaded up and trucking. Josh Rutledge, celebrating 2-month anniversary, says after 165 hours of SnowRunner, FS22 will be my Thanksgiving relief from stuck trucks. I can't believe you've put that. I'm actually not too far from you. Believe it or not, I used to play the crap out of that. But I just... the desire for that game has vanished. I'll be fine to never play it again. You know? But, yeah. I feel you there. 165 hours. That's a lot of snow running. No reason to be mad. The Chiefs are good. Have you tried? Yep, I'm with you. You're doing great, Paul. Good, good, good. Good, good, good. Do you see my comments that I'm not a supporter anymore? Yes, Tony. I don't have to even look because you don't have a badge next to your name. So it's... I already know just by looking at that. Big Frosty, are you going to play the update car mechanic yet with the new cars? The new cars aren't here yet, but once the BMW DLC drops, whenever that is, I'll probably stream it. Maybe, when that comes out. All right, let's get our little curtain open here. And we're going to load up a bunch of soup. We've got all kinds of soup ready to load up here. This is our only one of our only ways of making money at the moment, is selling soup from all our carrots and parsnips and red beet. Line up a little better here. So this is only 1 month of soup that we're about to load up.
Ow.
Close enough. There we go. Keep loading it up. Come on. Keep loading that soup up. I know there's more than that in there. Come on.
Is that really it?
Oh, is that all I got out of there? Come on, man. I thought we'd get more than that. All right, so I guess that's... Let's fast forward just a little bit. Let's go to... Let's go to, like, 1 o'clock. There we go. That gave us a few more pallets. Not as many as I was hoping we'd have a lot more. But hey, that's all right.
It's all right. It'll do.
It'll do. So 12,000 liters of parsnip soup and 12,000 liters of carrot soup. So it still should be a good chunk of money. Now let's see here. Carrot soup. Looks like it's a hit or miss. Farmer's market pays a little more for the one, and then the other one pays a little more for the other. So either way, it doesn't matter which one we go to. We'll just go across the street here and sell it right here. Top right corner, chat. About to get her done. About to sell it. We need a boost of money desperately here. Nice. Nice. All right. Little, about close to $85,000 right there. Not bad, not bad. 85 grand for 24,000 liters of soup. And that's just going to keep, that's going to keep happening every month. Because we've got so much root crop put into the factory, it's just going to keep pumping out soup. And it's going to mix in red beet soup now because we harvested that field tonight. Yeah, that gives us plenty of money to put down the old grain mill so we can get all the oats and the sorghum put into that. Then we'll start making flour. And then... I'll probably buy the bakery. I think the bakery on this map cost $50,000, which isn't bad at all. So we'll even have money to purchase that, which we'll probably have more money than that when the time comes.
It worked out lovely.
All right, let's go hook back up to our trailer. We'll build our grain mill. In the meantime, I do need to get a tractor set up working on one of these fields here, get it cultivated or whatever. So let's do that real quick. That's a lot of hours. I have 698 on FS22. It's not bad, not bad. How many hours do I have on Farm Sim? Like 2600 hours, something ridiculous, like super ridiculous. Yeah, something crazy like that. A lot. All right, what am I doing here? I want to drill. Man, pardon me. See, I don't know what I'm doing. I think I want to put some grass in one of the fields at some point, but I don't think we're ready for the grass yet. We're not quite ready for grass. So I'm going to switch this to something to... Like wheat. Yeah, we'll do wheat. That'll keep our upcoming bakery running full speed. So yeah, we'll put some wheat into this field here. All right, let's see here.
We'll do two headlands sharp with a 9% headland overlap. We'll generate the course just like that. And then we'll get it going, eh? Alright, we got that looking nice first waypoint. Let's go. We may or may not run out of seed. I don't think we will. But you just never know. Alright, so we got that guy working. We'll get the other guy cultivating. And I need to get the ridge maker put away. Colt the Field. Hello, Frosty and Chad. I'm late. What's up, Russ Curry? Colt the Field. Yeah, we're going to cultivate the sorghum field we harvested. And then I think since that had like an arable crop in it, we'll put some type of root crop in this field. Kind of like a rotation of crops. So we'll probably use the ridge maker at some point. Just drop that there and go get the cultivator again. I don't own a plow. Don't really need one because we have a weed remover. So it kind of saves money on ever needing a plow. You need a whiskey production? Whiskey? Alright, let's see if this guy knows what he's doing. Two headlands, sharp clockwise. We'll do 10%. Generate. First waypoint. Boom. Alright, he's ready to rock and roll. Alright, we got everybody doing something. We got him cultivating. We got the other guy planting. And now we're going to go build the grain mill down the road here. Multitasking. What is cheaper, a plow or weed remover? The weeder we already own, so we didn't pay a penny for that. So the weeder, I would say the weeder is the better way to go. All right, let's put down our new thingy, chat. Let's put it down. Put down, let's see here. Production. I'm going to go with this one right here. So the dump part of it will be right there. And the spawn part will be right there. That'll be perfect. All right, now we just got to do a little bit of landscaping. I need some landscaping stickers in the chat, please. I'd like some Bob Ross stickers, please. We are about to get fancy. Okay. Let's do some gravel. So that's where it'll spawn. This is where we dump. It's a nice little wraparound area here. All the pallets will spawn right there. We won't be going over that way. It'll be more of a turnaround here type of thing. Entrance. Exit. Yeah. All right. Grass. Oh, nice.
foot. Matches the grass. Beautiful. Sometimes it doesn't always do that, but in this case it does, so it looks very nice. Very happy with that. Alright, so that's all looking decent. Let's do a little bit of decorations, nothing crazy. Got a big light going on here. Put a gate. Non-matching grass is what killed the white farm for me. Yeah, that's always a pain when the grass doesn't match. Yeah, I agree. Kind of like this old fence. I don't know if we need an entrance. I don't think we need anything too crazy there. Like a gate. I don't think we need a gate. I'm going to put a little bit of grass around this area. Liven it up a little bit, eh? We got that. Yeah. Looks pretty good. What do we got? Buildings, production, decorations. Trash can out here. Don't have to get too silly, huh? Maybe a little outhouse if you got like an emergency situation going on here. No gate, shut your mouth, Duane. No gate. I thought I had a great idea. Your ideas are okay. I reckon they're all right, but I don't want no gate. I don't think we need one. I just don't think we need it. There we go. Little mess of bags floating around there. That's good enough for me. All right, chat. So there's our little grain mill. So here's how this will work. We'll come in like this. And since we're in Europe, we got these nice European trucks that can whip a nay-nay like no problem at all. Look at that. Whip a nay-nay. Get that tarp off. We do have to dump back here. All right, and then we gotta kinda do a nice 360 reverse back in maneuver here. Which I could have set up a lot better than I did, but. So bring it on up around here. There we go. Bada bing, bada boom. Dumping it on in there. That's all our sorghum we just harvested. And then we just hop up here. And activate sorghum. We almost filled it with sorghum. There you go. Activate. And we're also going to activate oat flour. Because I'm going to go run over to the house and load up the oats that we harvested. All right, so now it's spinning. We're looking good. That means it's making the product. Making some flour. Isn't that lovely? Do you like it? It's got that nice rustic look to it, huh? How does it taste with the grass? What about a flag or flags? I've drank some of my Christmas present from Duane, so don't mind me. Could you sell your header trailer? I could. Yes, I could. But I think that's only worth like $1,000. But you're right, I could. But I might still use it if I ever have to drive further away. If I end up doing a contract, I would probably use it. Look at these guys working, and I don't have to do nothing. Beautiful. Love it. Love it. All right, so we'll get all the oats out of here. And I'm saving the wheat. I'm leaving the wheat in there. That's how I feed my chickens. Frosty, is that a mod that makes it free to decorate? Yes. Yes, it is. Yep. And I don't remember if that's on the mod hub or if that's a PC mod only. I can't remember. I think it's called Free Landscaping. Yep. Because it can be a little crazy expensive when you're, like, editing the land. Like, the base game, when you warp the land, like, it charges you to do that. And I was like, I'll just get a mod that removes that bull crap, huh? But hey, our grain mill looks nice. Look at that. It looks like it belongs there. It almost looks like it's part of the map, like it's meant to be there. I like it. Good stuff. Now we got oats and sorghum activated. I could put a flag, but I don't really know what country we're in. It's just Eastern Europe. So if I did pick a flag, I don't even know what flag it would be, to be honest. I have no idea. They don't really... Germany? That might be the closest place. I don't know. That's the only reason I'm not putting one, because I really don't know what it would be. All right, but we're done here at the grain mill. We have nothing else to put in it, so we're going to close the lid and just let it keep doing its thing. So like I said, if we had canola or sunflower and all that good stuff, we can bring that here also to make oil. So it's a multi-purpose type of grain mill, which is nice. It can do more than one thing. It can make flour, oil, and pig food mix. Yeah, that's a good investment. All right, chat, we're kicking butt. How long we've been live? 2 hours, 18 minutes? Look at all the crap we've gotten done in that amount of time. We are all over the place tonight. We're getting fields flipped. I got to get all those bales picked up. We'll probably do that next. I haven't washed this truck off in quite a while. Let's get her sprayed down. Get her looking nice and tidy.
Yeah, you can do olive oil, but we don't have olive orchards on this map. But yeah, you can do olive oil, I think. Sunflower oil. Canola oil. You know, the basics. Alright. All done with the Aveco. Drop that right there. And we're going to go pick up some bales. We have an auto load trailer, so super easy. Just hook up and get her done. See how close our... Oh, he's still got a ways to go. All right, we'll pick up bales with... I'm hoping the International can handle the bale trailer. It should be okay. So I think we'll still sell... We'll probably still sell the bales for profit. I just don't know when we'll have cows. Maybe on the next episode, we'll think about saving up for cows or something. But I already know, now that we have the grain mill, I'm going to want to purchase the bakery to take all the flour to. So that'll pretty much take away all the money we currently have. But then, like I said, once we skip to the next month, we'll sell a bunch more soup and have another 80-something thousand dollars. So money is not going to be a problemo. All right, let's activate this operating position. We'd have about 11 bales to pick up. Oh, yeah. International pulls it, no problem. What's up, Timothy Boyd? Good evening. You've played FS22 for 460 hours. Not too shabby, laddie. Not too shabby. 2,000 more and you'll catch up to Frosty. Get the most used this animal there is. Pigs. Pigs. Yeah. I love the cows. Cows are my favorite animal, but they are a lot of work. A lot of time and a lot of they need a lot. Lots of food. But so do the pigs. The pigs like to eat. And I feel like the horses, they're like kind of pointless. Like they're cool. I like them, but it takes so long for them to become worth the money to sell. Like, it's just, ugh. It kind of bore me after a while, the horsies. All right, we're going to see where the best price is for bales. I'm guessing straw. It's going to either be that one market, farmer's market, or the animal dealer. The biomass heating plant is paying $143, and I think that is right down the road. So we'll just take the case for a spin. I like how the AI traffic doesn't stop for you. They pull out in front of you, but they won't stop for you when you pull out in front of them. They just keep on plowing through. All right, so yeah, we'll go to the biomass plant. It's paying $139 for straw, which is a pretty good price. Not bad. And by the time, if we did decide we want cows or something, I mean, by then, we'll have another field ready to harvest again. Wait, how do I get to this guy? This road leads to him. Yeah, Yeah, we're going right there, where the big beam of green light is.
Good evening, Mr. Frosty. I googled Zilonka, and this is what I found. Zilonka is a town in Wolomin County, Mazowieckie, Poland, with 17,398 inhabitants. It is located about 13 kilometers to the northeast of the center of Warsaw.
Yeah, I don't have a Polish flag. Otherwise, I'd put a Polish flag down. But we don't have one of those.
Yeah, it definitely has that Polish vibe. It kind of feels like Palawa. The Palawa map we used for quite a while.
We did like, I forget how many episodes we did on that series, but this has kind of those vibes.
I know you don't play mobile, but one thing I liked is what you honked your horn, the AI traffic would stop.
I've played the mobile version, but yeah. Not funny, the mobile version has a feature that is desperately needed on the main game.
All right, let's sell it, baby. Top right corner. Drop it like it's hot. Or not.
You don't want those bales? Okay.
All right.
All right, we'll just reload them. Maybe we have to drop them. Yes. Okay, there you go. All right, so we got about 12 grand. We got 12 grand out of some bales. It's not bad. That puts us at close to 72 grand.
There you go. See? Nice little chunk of money on bales there.
Wonder if there's a golden apple here. I may have already found this golden apple. I can't remember. I think I have been here, chat. Yeah, I know I've been here. But we'll double check just for fun. But I'm pretty sure it was like sitting on this pipe here or something. It was over here somewhere. I already found it. Yeah, I already found this one. Can't remember exactly where it was, but I do remember being over here and I found it. So that golden apple has been located. All right. No worries, chat. I did find that apple. I know you're very concerned if I did or not, but I did. Just use a German flag. I'm sure they want my... Frosty, am I doing something wrong? Every map I try to add a boat on, it just falls right through the water to the bottom. It might be the boat you're trying to use. It doesn't always work. So, like, on the white farm, I was able to use a boat in that little pond right next to the main house. But, yeah, some maps, it's not your fault. I would try different boat mods, maybe. Oh, and some of them you have to set it yourself. So, like, if you're using a mouse keyboard, if it's sinking to the bottom, use the left mouse button. Hold that and, like, drag left and right. It might adjust the height of the boat. It sounds weird, but try that. So it, like, adjusts the level of where it sits on the water. You have to decide how you want it to sit on the water is what I'm trying to say. It's kind of weird because boats aren't really part of Farm Sim, so the modder had to kind of get creative on how you... Does that make sense? Try that. What's up, Paul? Paul Grabowski. Hello there, y'all. All right, so bales are all picked up and sold. We're all done with that. And AI worker C has completed their task. That's probably the person who was planting wheat, if I had to guess. Yep. Yep, he all done. He did a good job, too. He did a real good job. I'm pretty happy with the way he did that. That hired worker deserves a raise. And 114 liters of leftovers of seed, too. Nice. So I'm thinking we'll put a root crop into this field next. So we'll get a guy working on that soon. He'll use the ridge maker there. Because definitely want to keep that soup coming in. Soup is how we survive. It's the survival soup series. What's going on, Frosty? Sorry I'm late. Was on a plane heading back home to Michigan. Oh, very nice. Hope you had a nice flight. It's probably nice and cold in Michigan. Yeah, I'm doing good, man. We're just chilling out on the Zelenka series here. Yeah? Got a refill of seeds. Drop that. And we'll get the old ridge maker going here. What, are you going to give him extra lint in your pocket? Yes. Yes. I tried that base boat you had. I have 980 hours, says Ian. Very nice. I've been in Florida working, so it's cold to me. I bet. You went from Florida to Michigan? Yeah. Time to put the hoodie and the sweatpants back on, huh? I haven't used a hired worker for the ridge maker. I don't think we need one. I'm just going to hire a normal worker. See how he does. All right, so last time the worker didn't work because we didn't cultivate. So now it should work. Yes. All right, we're good to go. Very nice. All right, so he's going to make nice ridges. We'll let him do his thing. It's going to take him a little while. Once he's all done, we'll hire someone to go behind him and plant. I think carrots is the next one ready for rotation because I already got parsnips put in that field. We just harvested red beets. So this field will eventually be carrots going in there. And since we harvested the oat field, that also needs cultivated. Got these guys running around like crazy. But I'll probably hold off on cultivating this, to be honest, because I'd rather skip to the next month and get some other things going. And I don't want to have to wait right now to do this. And then have it planted and all that. So we'll hold off on this field for just 1 month. We'll let it sit, which isn't a big deal. A high of 45 in Michigan. Yeah, that is a little bit chilly. The nipples are going to be a little firm. Hello, Mandy McKinley. Good evening. Would be nice if animals could get out and pin and you have to round them all up. I would not like that. That would be a pain in the butt. Boots and vest for me. I know it's going to be cold. I'm on blood thinners too, so it's even worse. Ugh, yeah. So yeah, it's definitely going to be chilly for you. But I'm glad you made it home safe on the flight. That's good. So we need to spray this field, I think. The lime, I'm not going to mess with the lime. It says the value's okay. I'm going to do a new thing here to save money. Like, if the pH is okay or better, I'm not going to put lime down. But the nitrogen is horrible, so we'll get that sprayed. And we're going to need that, we're going to need that tractor over here to spray it. Cut through the field here. We ain't gonna hurt nothing. Crop destruction's off. There is a mod that honking scares animals away. I think it was just deer, though, I saw. Oh, that reminds me. I've had animals off for so long because I used to hate seeing deer floating in the air. But I feel like this map is open enough. We won't see that happen as much. So let's turn the wildlife back on.
keep forgetting to do that. Where the heck would that be at? There it is. Wild animals on. There you go. All right, so we should see deer wildlife again. I've had that off for months. Time to get it back on. I like seeing that random deer in my field every once in a while. You know what I'm saying? All right, liquid fertilizer. Got about 58% left. That's actually a lot. That's 4,600 liters. That should be plenty to cover this field up here. Hired worker's doing so good. Isn't he doing great? Tell you what. Oh, jeez. Bigger than I thought it was. There you go. So if you're just tuning in tonight, we bought an old grain mill. We have moving right over there in the distance. That is turning two fields we harvested tonight, oats, sorghum. It's turning that into flour as we speak. We sold a load of soup. Our soup factory is packed with all kinds of carrots, parsnips, red beet. So that thing's going to be running for quite a while, bringing in the big bucks for us. Yeah, and we've just been flipping fields here. Once we harvest them, we're getting them set up and ready for the next crop. Staying busy. Putting down some fertilizer. It'd be cool if they added sod, growing, cutting. That would be cool. Have you ever seen a video chat? I know Joe Boyer has. If he's watching, he has. Because I think he was the one that posted the video a long time ago. But you ever... Okay, so anybody live near like a development or like a housing area that's having new houses built? And you know when they put in the fresh grass right after the house has been built, they bring in the truck flatbed full of sod. Well, look up a video of how, well, some ways, but there's like a harvester, a machine that picks up the sod from like a field that makes this. It's weird. It's hard to explain, but anyway, it's super cool. The machine they use to pick up the sod, put it into squares, and it like loads. It's weird. It's so cool though. It was very very cool to watch. I don't even know what the term is or what it's like. I don't know what that machine would even be called, but the video was super cool. What's up, Nathan Weagle? Mr. Vanderford, good evening. How's Justin doing? Hello, hello. Look at those nitrogen levels, bottom left. Going from red to Gumby green. Very nice. Never saw that machine. You gotta look up videos on that. It's like a sod packing machine. I don't know what it's called. It's super cool though. There you go. Got that covered easy. So even though that doesn't have like the perfect pH levels, that field's still going to be excellent. Yeah, look at that, 97 out of 100. So we're losing 3% because we're not covering it with lime. That's still great. And it saves us money on buying more lime. So I'm down with it. I think it's okay. I think it's all right. Still got plenty of fertilizer left, too. That parked up nice and purdy. There we go. All right. So we are, like, all caught up here. Pretty much just gonna let this guy do a couple more swipes, and then we'll get a tractor getting the carrots put in. I'm doing good. Just finished watching the Cape Strain. I have to pick up sod from a sod farm sometimes and have seen it in action. It's wild. Yes, Scotty Carpenter. So he knows what I'm talking about. It literally picks up the squares. It's wild. It's wild. Just like he said, it's like a wild thing to watch. Pretty cool. I don't know what it's called. Can go inside the piano manufacturer, says Paul. Can go inside the piano manufacturer? Can you go in it? I don't know. I think you can look inside of it. I don't know if you can. You go inside? Are you telling me you can go in? I didn't know that. Let's see. Piano manufacturer is right here. I didn't know you could go inside.
Oh!
Yes, you can. You can go right inside, chat. That's cool. That's cool. So, it's expensive, though. So, one day, when we have lots of money, I want to buy this place. It costs 140 grand just for this. And besides this, we're going to need the sawmill, which that's going to be another... I don't know how much this sawmill is. But we'll have to own the sawmill to be able to bring the planks over to the piano place. All right, where's the purchase point? Oh, right here. So the sawmill costs $120,000. So I'm going to need $260,000 to purchase this and the piano manufacturer. Then I'm going to need a piece of land, which the cheapest piece of land of forestry is down here. It's like $43,000. $45,000, and it doesn't even have a lot of trees. It just has some trees here. Or maybe it's this one. Nope, let's... Yes, this one right here. Plot 100 is $43,000. So this area right here. So I'd have to buy that. So that brings our grand total up to $300,000. Then I'm gonna need a trailer to haul the logs. I'll probably just use a chainsaw because it's just... So we're looking at over $250,000 to even think about the whole piano manufacturing, which I want to do. It's just, it's going to take a little while to get to that point. All right, so we got this ready to rock and roll. Let's hook up the... Let's use this tractor. It'll get it done faster. More power. Hook up to the root crop planter and make sure we got it set to carrots. And he can start working. All right, carrots are selected. You already have it, Paul? Nice. Yeah, it'll be a minute before we can afford all that. But we will, someday. Someday we'll afford it. I'm going to save a little money and do this myself, chat. Alt. Alt. Alt, Alt S? No. Alt H? No. Dang it. Alt C. Alt E? Gosh, I can't remember. Yeah. Please create a track first. Okay. Activate, lower. There's our first point. There's our second point. All right, we got GPS steering going here. Hey, look, no weird textures going on. I shouldn't have said that. Watch, the next row is going to be all crazy looking. Yeah, I shouldn't have said that. Wouldn't it be lined up right here? Why is it going way over there? See? Dang it. I'll just freeball it. I'll freeball it, chat. I don't know what GPS is doing. There we go. I have the government sign. Oh, okay, gotcha. Yeah, I'm not doing that. I'm not cheating on this series. I've used that before in the past, but not for this series. Why is it taking the ridges out? Because that's just how it does it, Brent. Yeah, I know it's not super realistic, but yeah, the only thing the ridge does is look good. It's more of a visual, realistic thing. It doesn't do anything for you at all. It's more for it to be realistic for prepping it. But yeah, you would think the ridges would stay, but they don't. But at least we can get planting done a lot faster now with this 6 meter spread. That first planter we had was a little on the rough side. Took quite a while to get things done with it. We've got some fresh carrots going in here, yes? Take that big loan out, Daddy. We paid it off, though. Sounds like you need the coffee production. I know I'm annoying. You've mentioned it quite a few times. Yes, you have. So did you try that, John, with the boat? Like, or are you not in the game at the moment? Just wondering if that worked for you or not. Yeah, I'm not really wanting to use many other productions on this series. This series is more based on what the map offers. Yeah. The survival series, I might think about the coffee production, but yeah, I'm not doing it on this one. That was a bait. Yeah, the first one was a very small planter. I think it had like a 2 meter work width. It was super tiny. I wonder why my stinking GPS is not working. And I can never remember these darn controls anymore, chat. Can't remember how to bring up that screen that tells, like, I forget. I just can't remember nothing. It's in here somewhere. Precision power tool, blah, blah, blah. Guidance steering, Alt-C, menu, Control-S. Control S. That's what was messed up. There we go. We'll set our path. And now it'll be set. When I turn around, I can get a perfect line coming back. I tried, but it either doesn't respond with the mouse or makes my creek go black and freaks out. Could be a Mac thing. I don't know. Might be. Is the other tractor cultivating? The other tractor is putting the ridge marks in. These big ridges. We already cultivated. Yep. So now, all I should have to do is spin around, lock on, bada bing, bada boom. Lined up nice, perfect. Probably is the Mac's fault. How many reactions we at to tonight, chat? Did we break the big old 200? If you are enjoying the show, I appreciate you being here. If you could be so kind, just hit that like button. I do appreciate it. This week's schedule, we should be good every day except Thanksgiving, of course. I'll probably not stream on Thanksgiving. But other than that, I do plan to do a lot of farming. So we might be on the survival map tomorrow night. I've definitely been wanting to get back into farming more because this game doesn't break on me like all the other ones I keep playing lately. I've been enjoying a lot of the ones we've been playing, but I'm getting sick of the games like crashing and breaking and things not working. It's frustrating. So kind of makes me want to just play a little more farming for a while. And when I get the itch for another game, I'll play it, of course. I made a cool dock on my lunchtime series and tried the bass boat, the pontoon boat, and the speed boat. No luck. That's weird. It's weird that none of them worked. $221. A lot of nice. It's not bad. 222 people watching and 221 reactions. That means almost everybody likes it. That's good. Makes me happy. All right, Ridge Maker guy, he's done. He's tired. He just finished the field. We're saving a little money by doing this ourselves, huh? Will you dress up as a turkey Wednesday night? No. No. I'm not your dress-up streamer. You know that. I don't do that stuff. All right. Get that turned around there. Come on. Why don't you dress up as a turkey? Yeah, why don't you dress up as a turkey, Kevin? And then you can post pictures in Discord. And we all can make fun of you dressed up like a turkey. I like that idea a lot better. I think that's a splendid idea, mate. I think I'll have to spray this field when we're done. And then we'll be ready to skip to the next month. Look at those parsnips all lined up pretty over there. Looking good. Then I got soybean growing in this field over here. And then all these new crops will be sprouting up. Nice. All right, we got to get this guy out of the way. I can't believe this thing needs fuel again already. Jeez. We burned that much fuel already tonight. Right. All right, he's all good. Can I get this whole swipe? Yeah! Alright, final swipe right here. Got the whole thing caught. Turn the AC off. Oh, I love the AC on. What's up? Oh, I thought reading the wrong thing. Dress up as a turkey and chase your ducks. You're talking to Kevin, right?
Yeah.
That'd be a great video, watching Kevin as a turkey. I'd watch it. That'd be a very good video. And I'm not kidding. I think it'd be great. And I think everybody else would enjoy it as well, and I think he should do it. So let's stop talking about it and make it happen, Kevin. All right?
Do it!
All right. Let's see what this looks like here. So yeah, only thing that's bad is nitrogen. And we'll get this field looking beautiful.
Yeah! Just give it a little spray down.
I love this tractor, this IMT. This thing's nice. Got that power. Oh, power. Alright, refilled on the seeds. Fresh and clean. Need to spray her down real fast. And we'll be good to go. Come on. Aaron Ashlock. Thank you, Aaron. With the $10 super chat. Thank you very much, Aaron. You are appreciated. Thank you, sir. Thank you, buddy. You're enjoying the show, sir. All right. So, yeah. I think the next thing we'll be investing in is the bakery. Because we'll have all the flour from our grain mill. That'll get the bakery rocking and rolling. Sell some bread. So we'll have soup and bread as our main money makers.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Aaron. He said be right back. I think he's getting, he's purchasing a turkey costume right now, chat. I don't understand why I can't see where I'm spraying. Kind of weird, huh? I don't know. As long as it's covering it. I think the ridge maker darkens the soil when you cultivate afterwards. Something weird happens where it looks like it's been fertilized, but it hasn't. That makes sense. It doesn't make sense at all, does it? That sounds super weird. Alright, so we just gotta hit this corner. That big red streak on the bottom left is just around, along the right side here. That'll be it for spraying. Yeah, so I think we're doing the chicken in the pot this year, where you dump it in the pot of oil. What do they call that? What's the term? Fried chicken, I guess. Oil. I don't know what you call it. Dang it. But that's how we're doing it. Dropping it in a big pot of oil. A hot boiling pot of oil. That's how we're making the turkey this year. My friend's bringing his stuff over, and we're doing it in the backyard, and of course probably having all the other stuff, stuffing and sweet potatoes and all that good stuff. go. I don't think I have anything else to do. We can skip to the next month. I just gotta check on the chickens, make sure they don't need any food. They should be good. We'll have to feed them next month. Yeah, they'll make it to the next month. Factories looking beautiful. Very nice. Yeah. Oh, I got all my scores except one field. Everything else is above 80 for our precision score. That's environmental score. Is that a nice? That's that a good? Is that a nice? pH values, beautiful. Nitrogen, beautiful. I know that looks bad, but because of the crop that's in there, it doesn't need any nitrogen. That's soybean, and that field has nothing in it at the moment. Yeah, we're good to skip. Let's go. Let's go to the next day. Going to the month of February. Off we go. Deep fried turkey. There you go. Sounds good. Deep fry. That's what I was trying to say. I know you like marshmallows, but you should try sweet potatoes with brown sugar buttery mixture with some walnut. Oh, I like it that way, too. I like it. I've had it that way, John, and I like it that way. But I grew up with the marshmallows. So they'll probably be that type. But I know what kind you're talking about. The walnuts. Oh, yeah. Man, that's good. Getting me a little excited. Yeah, Night Wolf. Deep fry. Phil. Yeah, deep fry. You know what I... See, you guys knew what I meant. All right, we're in the month of February. It's snowing on us. I'm going to go to like 11 o'clock. I like to give the production... that much more time to make more stuff for us. So once we hit 11-ish, I'll stop. Right about there. Alright, so we do have snow flurries. See how our crops are looking over here. I got a couple months left on the parsnip. Still looking good though. Here's our fresh carrots we just planted the month before. They just sprouted. So they got about 3 more months to go. But looking beautiful. I love the way it looks, too. It looks so good. Fresh. And then over here, we put in wheat. We'll have to wait quite a while on the wheat. That's going to take 6 months before we see anything there. The soybeans have 4 months to go. And then this field, we're going to have to decide what we want to put in there. I was thinking probably canola, so we can do canola oil. So, yeah, let's get a worker hooked up to the cultivator, get that rocking, and then we'll plan on putting some canola in here to get the oil mill running. And then we got deliveries to make, of course. We got to sell our soup. And purchase the bakery. So we can take the flour over there to make bread. And these eggs are spawning so slow because we only have 20 chickens. It's almost pointless to even have chickens on this map. When my mom doesn't do the walnuts, she gets an earful. Oh, they're so good. If you're not allergic to peanuts, use peanut oil or fried turkey. Don't have to worry about catching on fire. Peanut oil. Good tip. Good tip. I'll let my buddy know because he's doing all that. I'm just going to sit there and watch. Potatoes, says Brent. Yes, potatoes. I forgot all about potatoes. Which would involve buying a potato planter. We'd need something that can plant potatoes. Why? Because we could then make triple soup. But we'll see. I'm not too concerned about that. What am I doing? Cultivating. Let's do some cultivating. I'm gonna hire someone to do it, of course. I wouldn't want to do that myself. Right, Mr. Lewis? Is Mr. Lewis here? He knows I wouldn't want to do any work myself. I'm going to hire someone to do it. Let's go. No, we had a... So the church we go to had a Thanksgiving dinner or Thanksgiving lunch after church this last Sunday. And they had one of the ladies made exactly what you just said, John, with the walnuts. Oh, the sweet potatoes with the walnuts. And then Miss Frosty, she brought sweet potatoes with the marshmallows melted.
So I had to get a little bit of both.
I wasn't going to leave Miss Frosty's off the plate, or I would have got a stink eye for that. So I had to eat both. But they were both delicious. Very nice. All right, let's get this thing dropped. Why is it taking the ridges out? Turn the AC off. Come on. Mike Stilts, are you watching? Mike Stilts, are you there? I asked you at the beginning of the stream about your work situation, and I completely missed if you responded, or I missed it all. I apologize. If you're here, how's that situation going? Now that my chat's not moving quite as fast, I can catch it. And I apologize for not catching it earlier. Yeah, I don't know if I want to go with the potatoes yet. I think I'd rather get the other production up and going. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to go visit the bakery, which is somewhere over the rainbow. There it is. So this is a new bakery that was added with the premium expansion. It's a new looking, like it looks different than the other bakeries that the game has. And it is purchasable. And I think we're not allowed to go inside, but it looks nice. It's got bread and some good stuff in there. So we are gonna purchase it, chat. I think it's only 50 grand. 50 grand, I'll take it. 50 grand. So we are gonna get flour brought over here ASAP. How's that sound? And we're gonna activate. We're going to deactivate our windmill. It already went through all the oat and sorghum. We're going to deactivate cake, but we'll keep bread activated because we are going to run over the flour with our truck and trailer. All right, so hook up to our trailer. Head down to the old grain mill we put in a little bit ago. And we should have a good amount of flour. And I'm interested to see if that stack mod works. I'm pretty sure I have it activated. So, and it doesn't look like there's any stacked. What the heck, man? Why is that not working? I swear I have that activated. Shouldn't the pallets be stacked on top of each other? What's up with that, bro? Because I know we made more than 3 pallets of flour. There's no way. All right, we're just going to let it keep respawning and load it up. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Is that it? Oh, it ran out of space. Get out of here. How cheesy. Oats and sorghum. All right, I got to get that activated again. Sorghum, activate. What in the world is going on right now? Why is my truck doing a... Oh, the flipping windmill caught my trailer, chat. Look at this crap. I was too close to the windmill. I backed my trailer up too close, and the windmill's been smacking my truck around. Oh my gosh. Clean up on aisle 10. I was like, what is going on here?
All right, so I gotta remember not to get too close to that. That was just smacking the crap out of my trailer. My Anarchy Against Microsoft's OneDrive has deleted all my game saves and mods from my new computer. Thanks, Microsoft.
Really?
Ugh. I don't even use it. I don't use the OneDrive at all. I don't trust it. And you just confirmed that I'll never use it again either. Yeah, I don't use that. Can we count that as why? I don't know what you call that. That was pretty rough, though. I stepped away to watch the game for a bit, fast-forwarded to winter already. Well, we started the night in December, so we've went through January, and I just fast-forward, now we're in February. So, yeah, it's snowing a little bit. And I guess that's all I can fit in here, is 9,000 liters, which is better than nothing. That'll be enough to get the bakery up and running, I suppose.
That shall do it, eh? We got Coopstream in here, says, hi, Frosty, with the 13-month anniversary, says, wham!
Did you hear that big boom, too? The blabam! Thank you for the 13 months, buddy. Mr. Vanderford was in here a little bit ago, saying he just came from your stream, so you must be done for the night.
Hope you had a splendid episode of whatever it was you were playing, laddie.
I just bought a bakery, so I'm going to go take some flour to it so I can make some bread. I've used OneDrive for 3 years plus and never had an issue. Yeah, my wife's had issues with it. I've had issues in the past, so I just never use it. Seriously, congratulations. I've had my OneDrive locked for years now. I've spent so many hours reading forums and talking to customer support. How did you get yours fixed? He didn't get his fixed. No, he's having issues with it, Ian. Yeah, he didn't get it fixed. He's having horrible issues, like many of us have had with it.
Orlando Pena. What's going on, Orlando Pena?
Firefighter sim. That's an oldie. Nice. Putting some fires out, eh?
Putting some fires out.
All right, where's the bakery at? Further down the road. There we go. That's the piano factory, which we will not own for quite a while. But we do own the bakery, which... Trying to think the best way to get in here. We got these roads kind of tight getting in and out of here. Look at that. All right, that's easy, though. We'll pull in here. And we're pretty much just going to drive right over the delivery spot here. There we go. All our flour just went into our brand new bakery. We got about 9,000 liters, and it'll start making some bread. Beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful. That's one thing I don't like about that old grain mill. Is it stops producing once it hits 3 pallets. That's only 9,000 liters of product, and then it stops. And I do have that stack mod installed. I thought I did. Oh, just saw a deer. I thought I did. Maybe I don't. I don't know. I thought I did. Nothing is fixed. Yeah. That's no fun. I'd be so mad. I've got 40 gigs of mods. Just mods, not the game. 40 gigs of mods. I would be so frustrated if I lost all of it. Ugh, gosh. I'd be mad. I would probably get a little teary-eyed. I'm serious. I'd be sad. I'd be very frustrated. I know how you feel right now. All right, let's head over to the soup factory. We should have a good load. See, this will tell me. I'm hoping I see something stacked down here. Otherwise, maybe I did forget to activate it. Wouldn't be the first time I forgot to do something, chat.
Yeah. Let's see. Do we have any stacked pallets? No.
Hang it.
Maybe I forgot to activate it. Son of a big old butt licker. I don't want to load the game up all over again just to activate that, but I'll have to put it on my mental notes of things to do. Because with that mod, you can stack. The pallets will spawn on and stack on top of each other, which is super cool. Should get a little more out of there, I'm hoping. There we go. That's probably going to be it for that. Yep. All right, so we got everything out of there. We got 8,000 liters of parsnip, 8,000 liters of carrots, and 10,000 liters of red beet. So we've got a lot of soup in there. Lots of soup. That's nice. And we already know we're going to sell it right over at the farmer's market, which is right across the street. Remember when the fishing game crashed and you lost like 2 hours again? Yeah, yeah. So I'm so tired of games crashing on me. It happens, though. That's part of gaming. You know, it's the way it is. All right, top right corner, big money coming in here. We got all kinds of soup about to drop hot. Oh, yeah. Very nice. Very nice. About $90,000. About 90 grand, chat, on soup. That puts us at $104,000.
Very nice.
What were we wanting to invest in? I think another month and we'll have enough money to buy the piece of forestry land, which is 43K. And we'll need, I think it was like 120 grand for the sawmill. So the piano manufacturing might not be that far away. We might really be close to making pianos on this series. I bet you at least 2 episodes from now, I think we'll be set up to be able to do that.
Yes, I think so.
Alright, I'm going to plant... I'm going to go with the canola. I want to get some oil going. That's just more money. We already have the grain mill. So I think it's smart to get canola put into the field that's being cultivated. So we have that in the future. Alright, switch that over to canola. Very nice. Top off the fuel real quick. Yo. Right. Time to pay for rental stuff.
Nah,
it's lease to own, so I'm not worried about that. I think we've already paid off our actual loans. We paid those off. I think, right? Didn't we pay off the loans? I thought we paid those off last time. Yeah, loans are paid off in full. Only thing we got coming out monthly is leased equipment, which that total is 7,500 came out in January for leased equipment. That's not bad.
Cody Knutson coming in with his first live appearance watching Frosty Live. Thank you very much, Cody, for tuning in. Thank you for catching alive, sir. Thanks for taking the time to stop in and say hello. Appreciate you. Yeah, we're on the Ziolonka, the premium expansion map that came out, what, last week, chat? And this is episode 3. Been rocking and rolling on it. All right, so Canola is going to go into this field. And my guy already got finished cultivating it, so yeah. Looking good. That means all fields will have a crop in it. And we won't have to worry about anything else. I'm kind of tempted to go ahead and purchase the land where the trees will be and just start cutting trees down while that hired worker plants this field, because that's going to take him a little time. What do you think? Should we go ahead and buy the little forestry plot for $43,000? We'll still have a lot of money left over. I think I like that idea. It's my first time watching your live stream, says Paul. Thank you, sir. Anybody that's watching a first time live, feel free to say hello and thanks for tuning in. And thanks for watching replays all the time. I appreciate it. Believe it or not, the replays help me out tremendously, because that's where ad revenue comes in when people watch the replays. So thank you. I know not everybody can catch alive, depending on your job or where you live, time zone. So replays help me out tremendously. I've been watching all your videos for a few months now and yet never got alive. What's your favorite, you got like a favorite series you've been watching, Cody? Or you just kind of watch whatever it is I put out there? All right, cultivator. Running out of spots to dump crap. Let's just put that right here. Ooh, I gotta feed the chickens too. I forgot about that. Chickens need fed. Even though they don't give me much in return. They really don't either. And this thing here is pointless. I don't need this. I'm going to sell it. I forgot. We don't even use it. That's $880. I never use it, chat. All right, let's go hook up to this red trailer right here, if I can get to it. We're just gonna get a little bit of wheat out of the silo so we can top off chickens. I'm not doing okay because I find out my mom was in the hospital last week. Is she okay? Yeah, that's not good news at all, buddy. Hopefully she's doing all right. Yeah, that's not the kind of news you ever want to have.
Thank you.
Thank you. Who's that? John Solier. Thank you for subscribing about 25 minutes ago. I didn't hear that pop through. Thank you, John, if you're still watching. Thank you for subscribing. And speaking of Johnny's, we got John McKinley dropping a $20 super chat. He says, honk a tootie to wake up the chat. How's that? Thank you very much, John, for the $20 super chat, brother. And John's also responsible for all those stickers you see in the chat. He's our sticker maker. And he does a mighty fine job, doesn't he, chat? He's a good sticker-making son of a gun. That's enough. We don't need to put much in the trailer. See if I can swing it. Swing it in there. Thank you so much, John. And if Mandy's watching, thank you, John and Mandy. Thank you.
They barely take any food to fill up, but there you go. They're good to go. Alright, we'll dump the leftovers back in the silo. Wish this trailer had a tarp on it. Nice. Alright, so we'll let that hired worker continue planting whatever it is, canola. We're going to hop in our hot rod, and we're going to go down to field 43, or field 100. My fancy truck here, I mean, that thing's sweet. I'm also going to need to purchase a chainsaw. We'll just go with the still. My favorite one. And then we're going to purchase plot 100 for $43,000. It's the cheapest plot of forestry on the map. So we're going to grab that to start out with. We're going to buy it. And then we're going to head over there. So I'm going to go past... I guess I can get there by turning at the park until it turns into a dirt road and just head down here. There you go. Go check out our new plot of forestry. Thank you, John. Thank you, buddy. I'm off to bed feeling a little woo. Oh. Not all the stickers you did, most of them. You made a lot of stickers for me. I appreciate that. Made me real happy when you did that for me. And I know the chat appreciates it too. Have a good night, sir, and thank you. Thank you for the support. All right, how do I get here? I'm gonna make a right here. Woo! Got some whoopee to it. All right, we're gonna hit the dirt road. Follow these tree line here. And our new piece of land should be way down yonder on the Chattahoochee. All right, are these all my, I think these are all my trees, I think. Yeah, everything right of the road from field 82 down to here is mine. Mine! I own all this chat. Yes, I do. I like that. All right, I'm gonna cut some trees down. Get this place ready. I'm gonna be cutting them at 12 meters, I think. Get them de-limbed. 12 meters, let's see. Right about there. Just getting some pre-cuts going, you know. Because eventually I'll buy a certain trailer that's going to take care of this place. Mm. Boom. Oh, I shouldn't have cut that down. Ugh, gosh. I wasn't paying attention when I looked at that tree. That is not a fun tree to cut. Yeah, we won't be able to delimb this a whole lot. Dang it. That's a nasty looking tree right there. What is going on here? It's going to be a hot mess up in here. Oh, boy. Oh, yeah. Yeah, this is going to be a mess. Alrighty then. Yeah, shouldn't have cut that done.
What's up, Stewie Norfolk? Cutting party, yes.
I almost misread that.
Did y'all click that like button, says Ian? I don't know, did they? We need some Reba.
No. No. It gets hotter than a Hoochie Coochie. Hello, Orville Ward. That's all you gotta sing about is the Hoochie Coochie, and then Orville Ward comes out of the woodwork.
You're like, what you talking about? Hoochie Coochie. I'm frosty.
How big is this thing? That's actually perfect. Yeah, so I won't have to touch any of this. I'll just leave it the way it is. The auto trailer will pick it all up. Oh, these are some really crappy trees. I was hoping I'd have like some actual like nice trees to work with. These are all really poopy, chat. These are not forestry trees at all. These are crap trees. Have a good one, Fozzie. Get to bed, sir. Get to bed. Jacob Nungstia coming in with the gifted membership. Going to Corey Irons. Congratulations, Corey. And thank you, Jacob Nungstia.
Thank you, Jacob.
Frosty, you are a very awesome streamer, and you always put out good content for us to watch. Keep up with the good work. Thank you, Corey Arendt. Thank you. Very nice of you. Yeah, these aren't forestry trees, sadly. What a crap piece of land, huh? That sucks. I guess it is what it is, huh? It is what it is. Yeah, not quite what I was hoping for. And what really sucks is I can't delimb. Well, actually, let me delimb quite a bit of that. I'm surprised. Some of these big ones, not so much. Like, how's that not delimbing? That's a delimb piece, isn't it? That's weird. That piece won't cut. Go. There you go. That is an ugly tree, huh, chap? I don't know why this one, this right here, should be disappearing. Maybe if I just cut this. Yeah, something bugged out there. Interesting. What's up, Adam Small? Still can sell. Oh yeah, I'll still. Well, I'm not gonna sell them. They're gonna go. Eventually, go to the sawmill. To make wooden planks. But yeah, I guess I should have kind of eyed up the land before I bought it, huh? That was a mistake. I'm not sure what's going on right here. Yeah, that's definitely jacked up. I think I'm just gonna get rid of that. Something's bugged out. Get rid of that piece. Okay. So we got quite a bit of wood laying around. Nice little head start. Not a whole lot, but yeah, that was a little painful. So there you go. That's our land I wasted my money on. burn the trees and use the fire engine mod. No, that's not anything to do with what I need for this. Yeah, I need the wood so we can make wooden planks. But yeah, those are not the best trees to work with. But it'll work. It'll get the job done eventually. All right, so now that we know we got that plot of land, we can start saving up in the future for sawmill. And then we'll get as much wood over there in the future to make planks. And then after that, we'll purchase the piano manufacturing production. And then, you know, we'll just be making pianos. And from what I heard, I think Oregon Trees, the one night, he said it takes like 3 months to make a piano. But when you sell the piano, it's worth like $90,000 or something. Logging in the snow, yeah. I think I need to... And see, that's the other thing. Those type of trees, I don't think the log harvesters even support those type of trees. So I wouldn't even be able to rent a log harvester to delimb those. It would probably say, this tree's not supported. Because that's what it always says when you're trying to cut something down. Yeah, it usually doesn't support those type of trees. All right, how's our planting guy doing? He should be almost done. Yes, he is. Look at that. Look at the timing, chat. Look at the timing. I didn't even think about it. It just kind of happened. He's on his final swipe. How perfect is that? So we'll probably have to spray. Yep, all we'll have to do is put some nitrogen down on this field. And slam bam, thank you, ma'am. All our fields will have crops in them. All right, nice. Good stuff. I don't remember if those trees will work. They won't. No, they won't. But I think, ugh, yuck. I was like, we might even have to invest in planting the trees, the type of trees I want, into that piece of land. Ugh, it's gonna suck. That's gonna be poopy. All right, chat, we've been live for 3.5 hours. I'm honestly a little tired. The butt's hurting a little bit. Been sitting for quite a while. So we are probably going to call tonight. Got that topped off. Spray this down. Get it parked up. But a super productive stream for our series we got going here. So next time... We'll be skipping to the next month. We're pretty much all set up here to go into the next month. Actually, we could just do that real quick so we're there. Yeah, we'll sleep till March. March! We're in the springtime. All right, welcome to spring. Vehicle leasing cost was about $4,000, so it's getting lower because we're slowly paying things off too. So that's not really that bad. Let's fast forward to like 11 o'clock.
Very productive, Cesaric. Not bad, eh? I reckon it did pretty well. All
right, so yeah, next time we'll be back in the month of March, and we'll continue getting things done on this map. But let's get into flight mode. Give you a little look-see around here. So that's our main farmyard, which you've seen a lot of tonight because we've been working around the farmyard. But there's our carrots coming in, parsnips, soybeans still growing. There's our canola that we just planted the month before, and there are weeds in the field, so we'll just have to remove some weeds next time on that one. And over here also has weeds. Ah, crap. This has weeds in it too, chat. I forgot to get the weeds. Oh, did I forget to get the weeds out of there? Son of a biscuit head. Oh, crap. No, we can still use the weed machine, I think. Medium size. Yeah, we should be all right. That's our wheat field. I totally forgot we had weeds there. All right, let's go take a look at our oil grain mill, you could call it. Yeah, that stack mod must not be activated. Dang it. So we put that in tonight. We got flour being made for our bread. We bought a bakery. So that's activated now. Let's take a run down here to our soup factory. Made a few trips there tonight. It's been spitting out soup for us. That's our money-making production at the moment. But along with that, we now own the bakery we purchased, which is down yonder. Right down here past the piano plant. There it is. All right, so let's see. Did it spawn any... Oh, it made bread. I forgot we brought flour over here. Look at that. We got two things of bread, chat. We got our first two pallets of bread. Oh, yeah. Very nice. So that's good. That's good news. So there's enough flour provided at the grain mill to not run out of flour here per month, which is perfect. So we'll always have bread being made, at least two pallets a month. That's not bad. Nice. Yeah, that's our newest production there. Excuse me, chat. All right, so what do you think, chat? What do you think? Did you enjoy the show?
Did you enjoy it? Were you entertained?
I hope so. I hope you liked it. I had fun streaming it. I enjoyed it. Ian Oppenheim. Katie Deck. I think that's how you say that. Kevin Flores. Elizabeth Sturdy. Josh Rutledge, you have a good one, brother. Hopefully you get that all. Yeah. Good luck with all that re-downloading stuff. And yeah, that's painful. Aaron Ashlock, good evening and goodbye. Paul, Duane, Eric, Mouse. Thank you so much, everybody. All of you. Thank you so much for always hanging out. Hit that like button on the way out. Tomorrow, very likely, we'll be on the survival series on the Western Wilds. We haven't been on that in a while, so we need to get things back up and running on that. That one is pretty far along. I think we're on, like, that'll be episode 15 or 16. So yeah, if you've been following that series, make sure you tune in to see some new stuff happening on that series, all right? Thank you very much, chat. Have a great night. Thank you for all the super chats, super stickers, and gifted memberships. Appreciate you guys. We'll see you tomorrow around the normal time, around 8 p.m. Eastern, right here at Big Rig Frosty Gaming. Okay? For now, goodbye. Toodaloo. See you later, chat.